Okay, hey everyone, and yeah, welcome to the stream for today. Hey Zephyrium, how's it going? Today we're going to be checking out the new Sega Genesis Classics Collection on the PS4, 50 blah 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 games. Actually a pretty solid collection from what I read about. I haven't tried it yet. I went ahead and popped it in. It had like a big ass update. It ran me $30. Well, actually ran me $24 because I pre-ordered it with Amazon. But yeah, normally $30. And you get like 50 games. So yeah, it's pretty solid from just what I read. We're going to see if it actually is worth the money here in a second. I think it also has like online play. So if you had a friend, you know, across the globe and you wanted to play some fucking Golden Axe, you could do that, so that's cool. Yeah, it has like a lot of RPGs and shit. Anyway, we'll take a look here in just a second. I don't have a good overlay for PS4 yet, so it's just kind of going to be the game. I won't really have any chat on screen or anything, but feel free to keep chatting. I will definitely keep an eye on it and try and shout out what I can. Hey there, Gunnir. Salty took away. Yeah, collector's editions. What game did I pre-order? I got a fucking stupid deal. I think it was one of the Tales games on PS4. I don't know. I know the pre-order thing is legit. And that's not just me shilling for Amazon. I'm obsessed with Amazon, I'm not gonna lie. Even if they do treat their employees like garbage. But anyway. Hey there, Enderial. It is my one day off tomorrow, so I am going to enjoy some of this delicious rum. And we're gonna check out some Sega games, so I hope you're ready. Let us go ahead and hop on in. Okay, this is also kind of a test to try out the PS4. We're using an Elgato capture card. Don't mind me, I just spilled a little on my desk. but yeah, we're using the Elgato, so hopefully everything runs smoothly. So not only are we going to be checking out some games, but this is kind of like a little beta run here. Yeah, my man. Here we go. Sega Genesis Classics. I went ahead and loaded this up for like 2 seconds just to make sure there wasn't like a bullshit patch that needed to be applied. Okay. Oh yeah, nice. Got a little load bar there already. And please feel free to troubleshoot, like, if you see, or not troubleshoot, but if you see anything that I could possibly fix or need to adjust volume or whatever, just let me know. D3T, oh boy. Oh, also, this game came with a little double-sided poster, which was kind of nice. It had, what did it have? Golden Axe and Streets of Rage was the poster. It was relatively small, but it was cool. Yo, this intro, though. Gunstar, my man. Gunstar is fucking awesome. Son. Yes, best game. Oh, I fucking love Toe Jam and Earl. Shinobi. Altered Beast Power. Oh. This intro is great. Alright. No, it's, that was Golden Axe. You talking about the little Viking dude? Not Lost Vikings. Zephyrium asked if that was Lost Vikings. This game contains material which may not be suitable for people with photosensitive epilepsy, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, we're good. Well, I'm good. If you guys have epilepsy, you might want to watch out. Just saying. Room settings. What is this? Hide room labels. Time of day. Look at this shit. Really? That's kind of neat. So your room actually adjusts depending on what time of day it is. Look at that. So you can genuinely feel like an asshole when you're playing Sega for like 20 hours in one sitting. You know, I don't know why, but I actually really appreciate that. That's kind of neat. What is room labels? I don't know what that is. What else we got? Audio settings. Let's check these out real quick to see what we got. Yeah, just your basic shit. And games library. Okay, so that's our library. Oh yeah, look at that. All lined up. Ooh, that's a shit ton of games. And console settings. Let's check this out. What do we got? Save load. Yeah, I believe it has like save states and rewinds and all that good shit. Console settings. Emulator settings. Ooh, look at this. Wow, okay. Not too bad. Huh. A lot of good options there. Eject cartridge, really? Alright, let's check our input. Yeah, just normal shit. Well, make sure. Yep, just normal shit. Okay. And online multiplayer. Yeah, you can do on. Look at this. See, that is really cool. Being able to play Sega just across the globe. Hell yeah. That's what I'm talking about. We need a good SNES collection that does that. That would be insanely cool. And yeah, you just got your bullshit here. Got a badass Comic Zone poster over there. So let's check out a game. Someone in the Discord said Alien Soldier, which I'm really not familiar with at all. Oh, look at this. You can change the region. Oh, wow. Nice. And it even has extras here. What is this? Alien Soldier multi-tool. Use 4 different weapons. Fetching leaderboard data. Wow. Very cool. Whatever the hell that is. Oh, I think that's like a trophy thing. All right. Oh, and you can even favorite the games. Huh. Oh, yeah, it puts it on the other side of that die there. All right. So far, I'm really impressed. Let's actually see how a game plays here. Oh, this is nifty a bifty. Lost Vikings is really cool. I have the first one on Super Nintendo. Need to get that second one, though. Don't have that guy. So, Alien Soldier, if I remember correctly, you play as like a bird and it's a shooter, right? Oh, we gotta play it on super hard, absolutely. I've played this maybe like 10 minutes, I think, on an emulator like way back when. Yeah, this is vaguely looking familiar. Well, let's be a noob here. Homing Force, yeah, absolutely. And so we have like a Gunstar mechanic, I guess? Or we're like combining weapon types, maybe? And get some Buster. Oh wow, 4 weapons? Okay. Let's get some actual numerics here, yeah. And we can try out our shit. Oh yeah. So you have to hold A to change weapons? That's interesting. Sorry, just getting my moves down here. What is that even? Oh, you can enable like moonwalk in there. 0 teleport. Jesus. There's no way I'm gonna be able to play this game. Alright, well, we'll just fuck around in here a little bit. Ooh, stage 1, yeah boy! I wish I would have had this as a kid, because from what I remember what I played, it is really fucking cool. Oh boy. A slight input delay with my capture card, though. That is unfortunate. Oh, Jesus Christ. This guy sucks at this. Oh yeah, he really sucks. Damn. Maybe homing isn't necessarily the best weapon to go with here. Wow, half health gone. A complete noob playing Alien Storm. Nice. Need some new fucking weapons here. That's not gonna do it. There we go. Wow, almost dead. Oh, Jesus Christ! Those hurt. Look at this. This is fucking awesome. Wait, what is going on here? I'm out of force? I didn't know I had force. Game, please. Oh, shit. 1 HP. Quickly. Can I use anything? Oh, I see. You have a limited amount of force per weapon. Oh shit, that game just whooped me. That was literally the most embarrassing thing I've ever done. Holy crap. No, that might have been yesterday's stream. I don't know. Tried a little bit more. So, okay. I learned that we have a limited... Oh, shit. Limited amount of force. So let's just try and take it a little bit easy here. This laser is amazeballs, by the way. Holy shit, that's strong. And feel free in the chat if you have a suggestion on what you want me to look at next, just holler and we'll check it out. Just gonna be fucking around here. No real goal here in the stream, we're just gonna be playing whatever appeals. Okay, oh, and I just noticed we can actually see like enemy HP values. Come on. Ready? Oh yeah, suck it. God damn it. If I could just beat a mini-boss, I would be the happiest man in the world. Hey, Zephyrium, thank you for hosting. Okay, I can kind of like chill out on the wall there. Oh shit, I'm doing like no demos here. This is a game I would not mind playing more of and actually learning about because it seems really damn good. Though it also kind of seems like Contra hard. I don't know, maybe that's just because I have no idea what I'm doing, but it seems kind of difficult. Jesus. Alright, well, that was Aliens. Alien Storm, was it? Yeah. Really cool shit. So, I can go here and eject. Nice. It's kind of satisfying. Or Alien Soldier, rather. Excuse me, I said Alien Storm, which is actually right here. Weird. Alright, all you jabronis. Do you see anything that, is catching your eye here? I know I definitely see a few. Oh, Fatal Labyrinth. Fuck yeah. I'll have to try that out before we stop here today. So here's one of the downsides to this. I remember reading online, when I looked at the list of games. It doesn't have fucking Sonic and Knuckles. Or actually Sonic 3, now that I'm looking at it. Oi, oi, oi. There's probably a better way, but the best way that I know to play those games is on the Sega Saturn with the Sonic, Sonic Jam. Yeah, you could play, like, Sonic 1, 2, 3, Knuckles, Sonic and Knuckles, all that shit. Altered Beast, ooh. So we got some people talking about Altered Beast, Toe Jam... Oh, yes. What is that? Galaxy Force 2. Gain Ground. I've never even heard of that. Let's check out... Altered Beast is really one you can just easily pick up and check out. And little trivia here. I'm pretty sure this is actually true. This is my first Sega game. I used to go to a daycare. And I remember at some point there was a Sega... just there. I don't know who brought it or why it was there. But yeah, played the shit out of Altered Beast. And I actually was pretty damn good at it. Well, I mean, compared to the other children that had never fucking touched a game, so really not anything to brag about. But yeah, Altered Beast is fantastic. And then, you know, they tried to make... Well, you know, it might have actually been really good, but I know there was one on Game Boy Advance. Like a new Altered Beast, and I don't think it did very well. But essentially, it's just like a little side-scroller. You collect orbs, and these orbs turn you into like some kind of giant fucking monster. Which you then use to kill the boss. Oh, fuck! Oh my god! Jesus! Dude is grinding into me. Oh yeah, this is the shit. This is the shit. So you turn into like different monsters depending on the level and each have different abilities. Like if I hit the B button, I would do like this little kick attack, which is pretty nifty, like that. good for clearing out mobs. If you get to the boss before you've actually turned into a beast, you just have to, like, loop through the level. So you gotta make sure you get all of the orbs. Yeah, this game, ultimately, though, it is kind of goofy, let's be honest. And really, there's nothing to it. Like, it's very simple. But you know what? It was still the tits. It was still absolutely the kiddies' titties. We almost got this asshole, no problem. I do not want to lose a life here. But again, I'm not too terribly invested. Nice! Oh yeah, baby! Cool ducking animation. The voices are so good. This fucking red-brown looking motherfucker turning into werewolves. Yeah, Altered Beast is so good. Oh, shit. Alright, yeah, we gotta... Oh, God, I didn't heal in between levels. I'd forgotten that wonderful fucking gameplay mechanic. Alright, watch out for the tails. You gotta make sure you break those. I wanna say, like, a dragon erupts from your ass or something if you don't. Oh, boy, well, let's see. Yeah, there he is. That fucking voice, it's so good. Oh, and then that's one of the mounts from Golden Axe there, that enemy we just... Oh, fuck your ass with that. No! We missed, like, two orbs, by the way, so this is gonna take a while. Oh, shit. Oh, yeah, you know what the best way to handle those is? I forgot. If you duck, you can do, like, this fancy little kick here. It's a good way to handle those. Could you just piss? Yeah, thank you. Like, what? I don't understand what the deal is. He's like, oh, you're weak. I'm gonna run away. You think he'd run away when you're a fucking demon, but no, whatever. Power up! Power up! Oh! Jesus! Okay, here we go. Second orb should be coming up. Just a little. Yep, there we go. I'm just gonna spam that kick. And this one is really cool. We can actually fly now. Oh, and get hit immediately. Our B attack is this nice little AoE that will make your ears bleed. So naturally, I'm just gonna spam it as much as possible. Also, you can shoot out lightning, which I guess is alright. Not as cool as the ear bleed technique. Oh, no you don't, bud. Yeah, you can't attack if your tail doesn't exist for some reason.
Welcome to your doom.
Alright, what do we got here? Some kind of plant demon. Don't necessarily remember the best way to fight this, except for making everything bleed by just spamming that B button. God, it's so bad. I don't know necessarily what his hitbox is. Like, I think I'm damaging him by just attacking the eyes. But realistically, I can't tell you for certain. I don't know. All I know is things flicker when I do this, so it seems like a real... Oh, shit. That did damage. Seems like a relatively good idea. Yeah, boy. Ruining everyone's sleep right now that's trying to... sleep while on the YouTube video. Yeah, sorry. This is what you gotta hear. Oh no! So yeah, I might need to actually just attack the flower itself. Which, this knockback is kicking my ass. But see, when I actually shoot the flower, he doesn't flicker. You gotta need to just get in there. Fuck. There we go. Altered B. Oh! Check that out. You got like a fast forward. Oh no, that's really easy to abuse. What the fuck are you doing, Uncle Fester? Get up here. Okay, so L2 appears to be a rewind, and R2 is a fast forward. So that's kind of cool. What is even happening right there? I can't even interpret that. Alright, here's where we die, because we got killer ants. Or bees, or whatever. These are just... they're scary, alright? Yeah, I knew you were gonna spawn. Huh! Kick! Right in the groinus. Also, that looks like a pit, so... just take it easy. What's your deal there, boyo? Nothing? Alright, cool. This is our last life, and when we game over, we're just gonna go ahead and move... oh, fuck, that's dirty. Move on to the next one. And, speak of the devil, there he is. You hear this game over music? This is like from a completely different game. What is this music? That's hilarious. Okay. We are done with the Altered Beast. Nice. Always a classic. What else we got here? What else we got? Beyond Oasis. Isn't that like a kind of Zelda-y game? I think that's what that is. Also, I'm kind of triggered looking at Robotnik's Mean Bean Machine. That game. Oh, that game can eat several dicks at once. It's literally, it's Puyo Puyo. But it's, you know, us Americans, we didn't know what Puyo was, so naturally we just had to put Sonic over it. I get triggered because I'm trying to look for it right now. Hold on. What? Okay, yeah. This motherfucker right here. There is a Genesis Collection on 360 that I have. Sonic's Ultimate Genesis Collection. Which, again, was a really good one. But you had to, like, unlock other games. So... yeah, it was a pain in the ass for some of them, because I want to say to unlock one of them, I had to do some Mean Bean Machine, like, high score or something. Talk about frustrating. Also, I bought the 360 game 9 years ago. Damn. Quite a while. Okay, anyway. We're not fucking playing that. Let's see. What's jumping out here? What's jumping out? I know I got a Toe Jam suggestion, but I'm really concerned that if I start playing that, I'm not going to be able to stop. Landstalker. Let's try Landstalker. I don't know what that is. Oh, Climax Entertainment. Oh my. Gonna get some nut takeout here. The Treasures of King Noel. Landstalker. Ooh, is this... this looks like an RPG, doesn't it? Is this the Zelda game I was thinking of earlier? Toe Jam is just so good. So we're at the Gypto Ruins? What is this? Oh, Jesus. Hey, cool credits, though. I appreciate this. This looks like some fucking Equinox kind of, like, platforming nonsense, doesn't it? Wow. Oh, fuck that. That was a blind jump, dude. Come on. You're kidding me? Cool sound effects. Shit, and you can move objects and platform? What is this magical game I'm watching? Here's your money for the statue of Gypta. Nigel gets 2,000 golds. You are a very good treasure hunter. With that money, you won't have to work for quite some time. I envy you. What the hell? What was that? Help me, please. Who are you? I'd say Friday? Smashing. Kayla. Hey, you. Hand me that little girl. Oh, okay. Girl. What? They know I've seen King Noel's treasures. They'll do anything to make me talk. They'll probably even kill me. Who knows? So please, help me. Wait a minute. Did you say King Null's treasures? What's with all the jibber-jabber? I told you to give me that girl. Oh, shit. Kayla, come on. Run, hurry. Could be interesting. Okay, come on. Cool fucking Disney shoes you got there, Nigel. Ha 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 ha, you won't get away. We did it, she's gone. Hey girl, did you really see the legendary treasures? The name's Friday, don't call me girl. Okay, okay, you can call me Nigel. Now talk, I saved your life, you know. Tell you the truth, I didn't really. Quit fooling. Oh boy. Why were they, okay, you know what? Oh, we can't, like, actually skip this. I was gonna say, I kinda wanna just see what the gameplay's like. Great, take me to the general area. After that, my keen senses will lead us to the treasures. Is that right? Follow me, Nigel. I'm not your follower. Yep, alright, got it. Holy shit! Maybe I shouldn't have fast-forwarded. What is this? I've got a really bad feeling about all this. Oh my god. That is absolutely terrifying. He's not even trying to hold on. Talk about climax entertainment. Okay, here we go. Oh yeah, look at this. It's totally Zelda. Look at that HUD. I paid all my money to that strange big bird. What? The ship going to the island only comes once a month. You said, I don't care how much it costs. I want to go there right now. But 2,000 golds? That's more than I... Treasure's worth more than 2,000 golds, isn't it? I guess so. Well, in for a copper, in for a gold. Okay. Alright, so we got like this weird isometric shit going on here. Is this a save point? Well, it certainly looks like one, but... What is this game? Yeah, can't do anything here. So yeah, it's on a grid. It's not like I'm just like moving around in a 3D plane, so it's... Not terribly awkward, but kind of weird. Definitely gonna have to get used to it. Now let's start on our adventure. Okay, this clearly is like a pretty big RPG. So I'm probably going to go ahead and just go on to the next game here in a second. Looks really cool though. Gotta say, looks really cool. I may have tried this out once like a million years ago. Cause it's like super duper vaguely familiar. Woe and death unto those who step into this land. Would be nice if I could save, though. Oh wait, I could just make a save state, right? Yeah. Alright, life stock. What is this? Wow, yeah, you got equipment and everything here. Oh, hold on, wrong button. Nothing to use. Oh Jesus, this interface is weird. And yeah, we got our weapons here. Wow, cool. Very cool. Five whole golds, holy shit. Man, I wonder if I would have been really into this if I played it as a kid. I just didn't really play Sega, honestly. I had a handful of games, and very occasionally I would like rent something to play on the Sega. Like that's how I discovered Wonder Boy in Monster Land, which is, again, one of my favorites. But yeah, I wasn't too invested in my Genesis, which kind of upsets me. Livestock, nice. Oh yeah, that's actually increasing my health. Like, I'm up to 6 hearts now. Weird. Very weird. Yeah, I wish I had played more Sega. But I just couldn't put down this SNES. I mean, and can you blame me with... I had, like, Earthbound and Final Fantasy VI, all that good shit. Oh, we need a key, alright. Oh no! I didn't jump. What the hell are these guys? Huh. It's not letting me move, by the way. Would have loved to there, but nope. Jesus Christ. What is this torture? I'm sorry I fell. Holy shit. Oh my gosh, a man. That was a tremendously long river ride there. I have to tell Grandpa. Okay, I'm probably pretty close to a save point, but I'm just gonna go ahead and shut that down. Seems cool. Seems really cool, actually. No, I'll have to look into that maybe sometime. And we have a save now, yep. As you can see, you can save state at your leisure. Cool. Alright, let's see. Secret path. Masamoya saying there. Okay, let's move on. Shadow Dancer. I haven't heard of that one. Shining Force. Some big RPGs here. And we got the Phantasy Star games also, right? A few of them, at least. What do we got? You got 2, 3, and 4. Wow. I think that's pretty good. Again, never really played those either. Oh, yeah. Or, I said Monster Land earlier. I meant Monster World. Monster Lair. I did a Let's Play of this guy. I fucking love that game. It's beautiful. Oh, God. I kind of want to check out Comic Zone. Let's try Crackdown. I've played... Let me look up here. Crackdown... Which one is that? 2? I have one of them on the 360, which I thought was pretty cool. 21st century artificial life system. Yeah, it's like just a lot of orb collecting, a lot of free roaming, giant world. I remember enjoying it, but it was fucking forever ago since I played it. Whoa, hello. And actually, I think there's an... Whoa there. Cool voice. I want to say there is a new one coming out on the Xbox One. So what do you even do in this game, honestly? Oh, was it? Enderial says that 3 has apparently been delayed again for Crackdown 3. Good to know. Oh, shit. Oh, I got punched in the head. What the fuck? Okay, so I am a tiny dude on a tiny screen. Proto Army punch and kick. Replicant Army gun. So this guy over here is... Well, I just used a bomb, apparently. That guy was Proto Army, so he's... Oh, shit. Dude, I kind of suck at this, huh? Hoya! So how do I went prone earlier, and that was kind of cool. But I don't actually know how I did that. That's kind of cool, though. You can sidle against the walls. How the fuck did I go prone? Jesus, Ben, get your shit together, man. Oh, God, fuck. When you don't look at the instructions, this is what happens. Okay, so hitting A changes me to my gun. Okay, I'm slowly gonna learn here. Yeah, get fucked, boy. Whoa! This is a hot mess, though, for real. So what's the point here, honestly? Oh, now I got an alarm going off. There's an X here. Ah, we need to place bombs. Okay. Oh, there's a map on the very top of the screen with red dots. And we need to complete this objective. I gotcha. Fuck off, Rich. Jesus, last life. This was just the trial run, guys. We're just seeing how this game works. Yep, go fuck yourself. Game over. Let's try it again. Or no, we gotta continue. Nice. Alright, we set all the bombs. Now we gotta get out of here in like 40 seconds. Could you piss? Thank you. Now where is the exit? That's the question. I'm assuming this... Oh god. Staircase? Hey, we did it. Okay, so it's a really cool Well, I don't know about really cool. It's a cool game. But is the screen fucking small enough? Like, Jesus Christ. The screen is tiny, dude. And think about, like, you're playing this back in the day. So you're playing this on, like, a 20-inch, like, tube in your bedroom or wherever. Unless you're in the living room. But, you know, good luck getting your parents to give you that shit. So you're playing it on this tiny screen, and then on your tiny screen... Oh, fuck, they take two bullets? You have another tiny screen that you gotta work... Oh, my God. Yeah. So, I mean, I don't know. It's a little tiny for me. Gameplay seems kind of cool, though. You can obviously tell I'm not trying too hard. So yeah, it looks like it might actually be fun playing co-op. You could, like, strategize and work together and all that good shit. It's kind of shocking, though. Like, what inspired them to make, like, the 360 crackdowns? It's so different than this. Ooh, shit! Yeah, there we go. We're learning. Slowly. Oh, shit. He's around there. Oh, I got some missiles here. Oh, hell yeah. Almost out of bullet. Oh, jumped me. These guys, rolling panthers. Like, I don't need half of the real estate for the screen going to enemy descriptions. Now, I mean, obviously, I want to say if I play two-player, that part of the screen would probably be player two, but I'm not playing two-player, so fucking... Give me my screen. Cool game, though. Yeah, cool game. Let's get out of here. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Dynamite Heady. So, check this out. We can play the Japanese version. That is awesome. Dynamite Heady, when it came to the West, they were like, oh, the game's not hard enough, so remove, like, all the continues and make it infinitely harder. Remove the cutscenes, remove all the dialogue. And just make the game buttfuck hard, is basically what they did. So the Western version is, like, ridiculous. So it's cool that you can play the Japanese one. Gotta say, I appreciate that. Mmm. Oh, baby. Okay. Fatal Labyrinth. I wanna try this out. This is a game, another game I wish I had as a kid. I've played this emulated a few times. I guess I still am playing it emulated, technically. So this is a randomly generated dungeon crawler on the Sega Genesis. Yeah. Cool, right? Yeah, 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 I get to the game here. So it just fucking, it drops you in. It's already, it's all randomized. And this music, this is badass. So it does that thing for like every movement that you make, you know, it's a turn, so. Everyone else is gonna move. I am have no equipment and I'm fucking surrounded. This is a horrible start. Let's just get up here. Jesus. This is really bad. We got a black cane, we got a leather helmet. I am just trying to get a little bit of room here. Never knew this even existed, Indurial said. Yeah, it's pretty cool. To think that you could play like a roguelite back in the day on your Genesis. But then again, I guess Toe Jam and Earl kind of counts as one as well with the random generation and shit. Oh my god. This is bad, for real. Alright, give me a second. Let's check out. We have a black cane. We got a helmet. How do I interface here? Leather helmet. So your items, they're not identified, so you don't know if they're gonna fucking curse you, or gonna be bad, or maybe they're gonna be amazing. Unless you have a way to identify them. We do not, so we're just gonna risk it here. And you can see our AR there on the bottom left went up one, so that is our armor rating. And yeah, we got a little bit more armor there, and it actually changes your character sprite. This music is so fucking repetitive, I love it. We also have a food gauge, F, power being PW, gold being G, and obviously HP is hit points. So yeah, you slowly regenerate HP as time passes, and you also lose food as time passes. We are now a valet, that's interesting. These guys can be real assholes, so I'm gonna pick up the sword. before I fight him. But it's a really cool game, isn't it? Like, I think this is a really neat idea. Let's try out the sword. Equip the short sword. Did my power go up at all? Yeah, I guess it did. Oh yeah, they have range, these guys. And they put you to sleep. Jesus. So yeah, it would have been really bad if I tried to fight this guy with all those other enemies around, because... well, I would have just been getting hammered that whole time. Holy fuck, you're literally the most annoying thing in the world. Jesus Christ, he is still gonna kill my- okay, yeah, we're done. We're done. Brrr, 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 brrr. Oh, fuck, I love the Genesis sound chip. Okay, we'll take down some of these lesser assholes here. God, hopefully? Fuck. Okay, maybe get a little bit of HP back. Yeah, please. Oh, man. Yeah, he's about to get me. Oh, nope, we're good. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. I'm trying to remember if there's a way to, like, wait and waste some time to get some health. Also, I forgot we had a cane. Should we try it? Yeah, let's try it. Why not? Nothing to lose. Nothing has happened. Wonderful. And the cane is gone. I want to say canes are like one-time use spell effects, which are kind of neat. Oh god, I'm just dancing around this fucking bird taking damage. Come here. God, stop! What is going on? Like, holding the button a little too much. I need to just tap it instead of hold it. Gotta remember this is turn-based. Oh god, please be a health potion. An orange potion. Let's try it out. Well, our power went up, which I'm definitely not gonna complain about. Nice. And there is the stairs to the next floor. I've never really made it past, like, a few floors here. One day I would like to seriously get into this game, because it is really nifty. Now let's try out this leather armor. Don't curse me, bro. Nice. 2 points more on our AR. Good deal. Ooh. Take that, you jelly bastard. If you want to, these fucking little snail dudes will just dance around you. And they're really obnoxious. They're worms, excuse me. Alright. But yeah, this definitely would have been right up my fucking alley. Golly. So much regret from my childhood. Let's try stabbing this guy. Maybe we can get lucky. They're just the most obnoxious things in the world. Just doing one damage. God damn. Forget it. Get away from me. Be gone! We got more armor. Whoops. Ooh, here we go. We got a lance, a green scroll, orange potion. What the fuck was the orange potion? That is the power up potion. So yeah, it just literally raises your power level. That is amazing. I got some more food. 41 food. And shurikens being a throwing weapon. I think... is the lance? The lance isn't a throwing weapon, right? I should be able to just equip it. Yeah, okay, nice. Very nice. Yeah, let's go ahead and just keep that on. Get our revenge on this jackass down here. You know, one of my favorite things on, oh, wow. Nice. On, the game Air Guys on the PS1. It was like a fighting game, kind of Smash-esque in that, hey, level up. in that it was like a collaboration, so you fought, it was a fighter game with a bunch of just random square, or not square, but like PS1 characters. It had a lot of Final Fantasy VII characters. But yeah, so that game, it was really fun. It was a good fighter, I guess. It was fancy. But it had like this randomly generated dungeon mode, where you just explored this huge dungeon. Kind of similar to this, but just like imagine PS1. And I loved that. That was fun as hell to me. Ugh, good shit. Look at this lance just tearing ass. That's absolutely what I want to see. More shurikens. Shurikens, obviously, we just throw those. And a short bow. Do I have like a weight limit? That's what I want to know. Despite having played this game a few times, I really don't know much about it. Usually what happens is I end up getting cursed and then I just fucking like get murdered by a ton of enemies. Let's try out this gray ring, shall we? Put it on. Feel much better. Good deal. Getting lucky with the effects. It's a flame ring. Now, ask me what the flame ring does, because I have no fucking clue. No, it was like... Ugh, let me get comfortable here. Ooh, sorry about that. So yeah, you would take the... there was like two random characters. They're just like rando heroes. There was a male and a female avatar that you would take into the dungeon. The actual FF7 characters you just would only use in the fighting game. But it had like materia that you could collect, and obviously a lot of equipment. It had a food system similar to this. I remember eating a lot of grass, which cracked me up for some reason. But yeah, it was cool. It was really cool, actually. I'm trying to think of what my first like roguelite would have been, and it probably was Toe Jam and Earl. But after that, Air Guys, yeah, was definitely a contender. Because I played a lot of that. I don't know if it wasn't necessarily a roguelite, because... Well, no, it may have been. I don't know. I just work here. Leather shield. Can I equip a spear? And the leather shield. Yeah, Gungnir is showing some interest in that. It is pretty cool. Obviously, it's aged. It's pretty fucking old. But it was neat for its time, for sure. And yeah, I can totally rock a spear and a shield. Noise. Though I feel a little weird being a filthy spear user, I gotta say. Ugh. Shit, we should play Air Guys on one of these streams. Might have to check that out. Spears are cool, Asamoya says. Wow, cool dead end here, by the way. Also, I'm like totally absorbed into this game, aren't I? One of the brutal things about this game is I don't think there's any sort of like unlockables. Like, you know, on Isaac, you play Binding of Isaac and then you get fucking murdered. But at least, you know, at least I unlocked a few items along the way. But yeah, in this one, I'm pretty sure you just go all the way back to the start with nothing. So I don't even know what you use gold for. I don't think I've ever encountered a shop. Also, where the hell are the stairs? Oh, God. Watching that food meter tick way down. And I want to say, you can actually eat too much in this game, but that's with a question mark at the end. I don't know if I'm remembering correctly, but I think you can. What was that? Oh, I guess I fucked around too much and the enemies respawned? That's interesting. I didn't know that happened. Usually I can find the damn stairs. Today I'm feeling a little special though, aren't I? Alright, fuck off, dude. Yeah, Sleepy. Not good when enemies are all around me. Oh boy. Just get away from the mage. How does a bat parry? Come on. Fudge. Alright, you ready, you piece of shit? I'm gonna throw this shuriken right up your ass. Yeah, 8 points of damage. Nice. Seriously, guys, where are the stairs? I feel like a goofball right now. You know, the way the interface is here with the Sega Collection, I could probably get the chat over there on the right if I really wanted to. If I decide to come back to this later. It definitely seems pretty cool so far. It's running really well. Yeah, I am totally fucking lost, though. Do I need to actually touch the walls? Or I think they just automatically reveal themselves. Oh! Hey, buddy. What the fuck? What am I missing here? This is crazy. It's only the second floor. Why are they're trying to bamboozle me here. Oh, Christ almighty, this guy. Nice miss. Excellent. Lufia 2. Oh god, I want to play Lufia 2. Actually, that was another game that had the roguelite element that I played as a child. So yeah, Lufia 2, eventually in this story, you could unlock the Ancient Cave, which was a randomly generated dungeon, which is cool. Yeah, Ancient Cave, fuck yeah. Gungnir's talking about it in the chat. I don't know where the fuck the stairs are, guys. I feel like a proper goofball right now. But yeah, Ancient Cave, you would unlock it in the story. Whoa, hey there. And after you beat the story mode, you could just do the Ancient Cave right from the main menu. And the cool thing about that is you could bring any of the characters from the story that you wanted into the Ancient Cave. Whereas, if you did the Ancient Cave in the story, you could only bring the party that you had with you. So yeah, it was a really cool feature that added a lot of replayability to Lufia 2. That is a top-notch game, in my opinion. And hey, Ouija, welcome to the stream, where we are stuck on floor 2 of a game called Fatal Dungeon. There's no stairs. Just period. Oh, what the fuck was this? I didn't know I could do that. I mean, it doesn't help us, but Ouija says Airgeist was a very strange game, but I remember renting it as a kid. Yeah, I'm lucky enough to actually own the sucker, and yeah, it's weird but cool. Gungnir is talking about the ending to Lufia 2, which was pretty intense. I don't want to go too much into it because I might actually play that one day. But yeah, it had a really solid ending. Yeah, this is a really cool game. Normally, it's a lot more interesting because you're not fucking stuck on the first floor. But maybe, okay, so here's what I'm thinking happened, guys. And actually, it's no longer a thought. It's definitely a confirmation. So here's what happened. I spawned on the second floor. And I proceeded to think that the stairs that I spawned right next to were the stairs I just took. But in actuality, those stairs are the way to the next floor. I'm just being a complete dumb butt. So we need to get back up there. if this fucking mage would ever just get off my jock for like 2 seconds, that'd be wunderbar. Yep, nope, we're asleep. Can't you tell how asleep I am with what with my spear just fully extended? Then again, I'm pretty sure we've all woken up with our spears fully extended. Am I right, guys? Jokes! Okay, fucking hell. Oh god, this way. Please. We are actually going to die. Oh, there it is. Sephirium. Thank you. Why do I get bits after the worst trash? Honestly. So yeah, I spawned next to those stairs, and I assumed that they were the stairs I just took. But you need to remember in this game, the stairs that you just take, yeah, they disappear after you take them, so. Golly, that was stupid. Oh well, we did a little bit of grinding. So those crystals are bad mamma jammas right there. Need to be careful of those guys. Oh god, mages everywhere! Let's try out, you know, we should just spice it up a bit. We picked up a different ring earlier. Let's try it out, the blue ring! The armor has been strengthened! That actually sounds pretty solid. This is the armor ring. Okay, cool. Take that. I want to be there helping it since... No, I made no pro- I actually started... Ouija's asking about my randomizer stream yesterday. I actually made no progress. I started a different seed just to try it out, and I just suck at Legend of Zelda, man. At least randomized. I got stuck because I needed bombs and Super Metroid, and I just couldn't find the bloody things. It was just a hot mess, honestly. Oh yeah, here we go. We need to get this snail out of here, like, as soon as possible. Fucking god, the sleep. Oh, Moses. Zelda is really rough in the beginning, but once you learn where the chests are, it's not so bad. Yeah, I need to do some studying before we try that nonsense out again. That is for certain. Let's throw one of these shurikens at the snail and miss and then fall asleep immediately. Seems like the kind of thing a checklist or something would be useful for going near. Yeah. Yeah, I just, realistically, just need to learn everything. It's the simplest way. Oh, good, we got the- Oh, fuck. There's a crystal in here, though. We do not want to contend with him right now. Look at all these mages! Ah. They don't do damage, but they put me to sleep for fucking decades. Well, I guess we're fighting a snail. There's actually an item tracker, map tracker for both games. It's pretty handy, says Ouija. Ooh. Alright, one more shuriken. We're just fucking missing. RNG is not on my side right now. You've destroyed the snail. And now we're a level 3 leader. Wonderful. Leather armor. We already have a relatively decent set of leather armor, so not gonna bother changing. Oh, you see, okay, 7 damage from that crystal. So just watch this. I'm gonna try and fight this guy. Maybe we'll get a little lucky with the parries, but he can dish out some damage really quickly. Phew. Looks like we got a little lucky today, though. Nice. There's an axe on the floor. I'm hoping this is better because I need to do some more DPS at the moment. Also, I just realized I am pretty invested in this, aren't I? So, we're still at 8 power with this. What do we got? 7 points of damage versus 2 points. What? Okay, that's a little confusing, but I guess we'll just roll with it. Blue ring. Orange potion. Wow. So the orange potion is a power-up potion. So we're just gonna raise our power stat. And yeah, suddenly this became a Fatal Labyrinth stream. I apologize. 14 damage! Fuck. Thank you, Ouija. I would appreciate that. I'm gonna post it in our Discord, which, if you haven't joined the Discord, feel free to. It is totally chill. You are not obligated to chat at all. You can lurk if you want, but I would love to have you. Seriously, it helps me get through my workday when I can just look down at my my phone or my watch and just see you guys chatting. It is so great. Yeah, double sleep. Fuck. Get axed. There we fucking go. So how did I open that? Okay, so if you hit A on the wall, you can find secret doors. Good to know. Is there anything worth hanging out here for? A few more rooms I haven't explored. I'm getting sleepy. No shit. Hey, alright. Let's check out this bottom left room. Yep, just jack shit. Nice. Come here, you bastard. Full health. Yeah. Yeah, I think we're doing alright. Again, I'm not overly familiar. This is about usually where I stop playing the game. So, yeah. Alright, we got an ice bar here. Just get him out of here quickly. 12 points of damage. Oh. Yeah, nice. Can drop him in one hit, though. Can't complain about that. Oh, what? Two axe? Or no, that's a short bow. So here's a question. I don't know how to use a bow. Like, oh my god, you fuck. Dancing around me. Can't carry. Oh, alright. So we do have a weight capacity. And, yeah, I guess we could just drop this knife, huh? Take the battle axe, which is what we're... No, we're using a hand axe. Let's see what a battle axe has to offer. Now, this sounds interesting. 15 points! Oh, shit, dude. Double the strength. That sounds good. Throw some of those short swords, Zephyrium says. Yeah, that is a great idea, actually. Just start chucking swords around. My kind of jokes, Zephyrium. Gonna ask some questions. Ooh, yeah!
Ooh, yeah!
Hey, is that an orange potion? Purple potion. I'm not gonna gamble on potions right now. Because you could get some debilitating effects out of these guys. Alright, 4 points. Nope, see ya. Yeah. Oh, shit. There we go. This axe is very nice. Is that yet another axe I see? Let's, yeah. Get rid of this trash lance. Sure. Would have been fun to throw, though. Yeah, one of the big complaints that I have with this game, I do actually really enjoy the music. But the loop is just way too short. Like, come on. So how do we use bows? Let's try this out. We have four short bows here. And if I typo while I speak, forgive me. I had a little bit of rum before the stream started, so. Okay, I don't... Like, I try and equip it, but it just kind of fucks off. Oh, I'm being a dumb butt. Here's equip. Here we go. Okay, equip the short bow. Seem to lower my armor rating, but that's because I lost my shield. So do I have ammo here? Or is it just spamorama? Yeah, that's not happening. Okay. Not gonna fuck with bows right now. Get our axe. Get our leather shield, and we're good to go. Nice that the game doesn't count equipping shit as a turn. Let me guess, a secret door? Oh, wow, amazing. I thought I saw some stairs down here. Still playing a Fatal Labyrinth here. Hope you guys are enjoying it. If you need me to move on, just holler in the chat, and we'll try and get through this. This game is fun as shit, dude. Oh, what is that? Ooh, I don't know if I've seen that enemy. Just let me throw a barrel at it. 8 points of damage. Oh yeah, that looks intimidating as fuck. What are you? 1 point. 10 points. Ooh, okay. Decent evasion, a lot of health. That was literally a robot, guys. And there's a fuck ton of weapons here. Or, I don't want to throw it. I want to discard. I might need it later. Alright, so we got a short sword. Lottie frickin' da. A short sword. Oh yeah. Good shit. And here comes the hat trick. A short sword. Wonderful. Where is the exit? Hey, a secret... Wow, I actually had to find a secret door to get out of there. Oh! Is that a damn ninja? We're fighting robots, we're fighting ninjas. We're fighting fucking Final Fantasy crystals. Oh yeah, we're taking a lot more damage on this floor. Okay. Oh, we've destroyed a ninja. Oh god, ice bars! Here it is, rip run. Rip. No, get shattered, you fucking piece of ice. Oh, what is that? Is that a snail? That is a snail, okay. Looked kind of funky. I am digging this game. I am not good at the roguelike, Superium says. Yeah, it's neat, right? And again, you could have had this on your Sega Genesis. Like, that would have been the coolest shit in the world. Ugh. Well, actually, we got a lot of health back. I was gonna say we need to try a potion, but not really. You regen relatively quickly here. This room is absolutely gonna hammer my ass, though. So, yeah, let's try and get this ninja out of the way. Evasion for fucking days, mate. Holy Christ, that was like 8 dodges in a row. Yeah, get over here. Make sure only one enemy can hit me at a time. Let's gamble here. And try out purple. Okay, I'm surrounded by darkness. Yeah, we got ninjas. We're just asking what kind of dungeon this is. We got ninjas, we got robots. We got all manner of fuckery here. So the darkness potion has blinded me. And you might think it disabled my map, but no, I just can't see dick, Captain. Look at this. Oh, this is miserable. Holy shit. Does this wear off? Oh, good. Wears off relatively quickly. And look at this. I guess the robots don't mess with you unless you attack them. That's good to know. That is actually really good to know. It's just gonna be a short sword. Yeah. I wish you could see what kind of items they were before you picked them up. What's this, a battle axe? Oh, a hand axe. Alright. Oh, more meat on the bone. So that word kind of triggers me as a Danganronpa 2 fan. Meat on the bone. That pissed me right off. Okay. Anyway. Oh, we are a battle man. Yes, I am battle man. And you can see, my HUD is now red. And my food is massive. And my character is moving really slow. And that is simply because I ate too much. Yeah, the game punishes you for trying to eat a little bit too much meat. Is this a secret? Yeah, nice. Oh, we're in this is where I started. Yeah, nice. So I guess this is the game's way of trying to teach you that secret doors exist. Holy shit, this game is fun, for real. Gluttony shall be punished. Yes, it shall, Zephyrium. Yes, it shall. Let's get the hell out of here. Well, let's check out this trash spear first. Short sword, be gone. And it is... Oh, no, it is actually a spear. We had a lance earlier. So let's see if the spear isn't going to curse our asses. Nope, didn't. Weapon, 1 point. So I'm guessing spears and lances are more tailored for just throwing? Seems to be the case, because their attack power is really low. And I almost ate some more meat on the bone. Control yourself, Alan, please. Oh yeah, here we go. Jesus, the amount of damage he just did. One enemy. Ooh, orange potion. Ooh, piece of candy. Power up potion. We're getting a ton of these. Permanently raising our power stat by 1 point. Very nice. Let's see if my fat ass can keep going through this dungeon. Realistically, I probably should be killing the robots, but... Eh, I don't know, man. Secret? Yeah. I'm learning your ways, game. Probably another secret down here on the bottom. If I had to guess. Oh, nope, just regular path. Oh shit, this is not a good room. Back up. Always try and like pigeonhole your enemies here. Yeah, alright ninja, you're next. Get this ranged bullshit out of here. If I remember correctly, going back to air guys, I think, like, the different foods you ate would influence what, like, your stat gains were. Like, if you ate more meat, you would get, like, more protein, so, like, more strength. I think that was a thing? It's kind of hazy, but I remember some crazy bullshit like that. Purple potion. We don't really know what this does yet, do we? Oh, no. No, we did use that. Yeah, it's the blinder potion. And you can also throw potions as, like, projectiles. Thank you for warning me, Sephirim. He's like, that's the darkness potion. Never got too far in dungeon mode in air, guys. Yeah, says Ouija. I don't think I ever beat it. Also, these fucking... Ooh, we're about to die. Alright, guess what? Take you the hot bullets of purple potion. Well, I did a little bit of damage. Can't complain about that. Yeah. Just melts your eyeballs when you drink it, that purple potion. Alright, you demanded more inventory. Spear! And, short sword. Yeah, boy, this is not worth it, honestly. Alright, get down here. Oh, we were at 7... There it is. That's what happens. And just like that, it's so quick, right? You're fucking done. That game is really cool. Oh, you can't... Can you continue? Really? Okay, so... I guess it's not as roguelite-y as I thought it was. I don't remember continues being in the game. That's fucking cool, though. Yeah, Fatal Labyrinth, Sega Genesis. Really, really solid game. I like that. Let's get the hell out of here. Alright. Does anyone have a preference on what we check out next? Quite a few games here. And quite a few I actually don't know the names of. Like, I don't recognize. Oh, God. Sonic Spinball. Fuck. Rystar... Fantasy Star. Kid Chameleon. Didn't really play much of that. Spinball. Okay, only do that if you're good at Sonic Spinball, Moonsidian says. Well, I really like you, Moonsidian, so I'm not that great at it, but we're gonna do it anyway. We'll just check it out. So this is another one that I rented. Never owned. It was a rental. Because I really like Sonic. Oh yeah, what do we got in the options menu here? Oh yeah, that Genesis music, holy fuck. far as I ever got the second level, Moonside Inn says, yeah, I think that's actually true for me as well. I remember this level, and was two, which one was two? Was that, that wasn't lava, was it? I can't remember now. Yeah, I don't think I ever got past that level. This one is really the only one I ever played. So we have the C button, activates both of our flippers. Otherwise, whoa! A is your left, and I think B is your right. And your goal here is to, you have to collect like 18 Chaos Emeralds or some bullshit in this game. There's a fuck ton of Chaos Emeralds. Level 2 is a lava. Okay, wow, I actually remember that. Level 1's pretty forgiving here at the start, because you can just jump off that platform before the dragon gets you. Fuck. I kinda suck at pinball. Good timing, Sonic. Really good timing. We just bought Pokemon Pinball on the Game Boy Color, like the actual cartridge, and I was trying to play that, and it's just like... The amount of fucking death that I have in that game is unreal. And also the amount of Pika you hear is unreal. Fucking Pikachu sound effect is really obnoxious. And okay, so you hit both the rings, you drain the swamp, thank you, Trump, and then you can get to the fucking you can get to the Chaos Emerald now. We just gotta find a way up there. Ouija says, also to be fair, the pinball physics in this game are trash, which yeah, they're pretty trash. I mean, Ouija said terrible, but I kinda auto-translated to trash. Oh, yes! Yes, sir! Spinball. It's a cool game, but you just have to be really into pinball and Sonic simultaneously. Which, I'm into one of those things. But even then, that's like a hard maybe. I really like... Oh, for fuck's sake, Sonic. You got the OG Sonics on the Genesis. I love those. Sonic Adventure 1 and 2. I love those. Did I play any others? That's the question. I don't think I actually really played any other Sonics. Because I played like a little bit of Generations, which was neat. And... Shit, man, that might be it. Not a lot after Adventure. Fucking get off the platform here, man. There we go. Oh, no, get the ring! Drain that slime. There's something really cool about pinball games, though. Not gonna lie. It was cool that also in Adventure, they kind of like brought this back with the little pinball game in the casino zone. Oh shit, we got the safety lids, guys. Hell yeah. What am I watching out for, exactly? Alright, we need to get in these pipes. So that is exactly what I'm not doing right now. Thank you. Oh yeah, boy! Jesus! I'll come right to you, dragon. No need to exert so much effort. Alright, I think that's Sonic Spinball, ladies and gents, and everyone else. have you ever heard a more Genesis song, though? Holy shit. That was Sonic Spinball. Fun game. But yeah, hope you're into pinball, otherwise, good fucking luck. I remember being kinda done with that pretty quickly, when I rented it. I enjoyed it, but I just suck an ass at pinball. A faux show. So what else we got? Anything popping out at the moment? Gunstar, always solid. Sword of Vermilion. I don't know what that is. Sounds like another RPG-esque kind of game. Also, I don't know what Super Thunderblade is. I'm gonna go ahead and guess this is a shooter. Let's check it out. And if it is a shooter, then I probably played it on an emulator at some point. Oh, check out that title screen. Is that a real title screen? This looks like some fucking just bootleg shit. Okay, well, let's check it out. Yeah, looks good. Looks good. Players? 7. Yeah, totally. Thank you, Moonsiding. That's actually the game I was thinking of. I couldn't remember it. Hong Kong 97. Moonsiding asked if this is Hong Kong 97. Yeah, totally. Also, cool cutscene here. Alright, here we go. So, it's fucking Fantasy Zone or whatever that game's called. Oh, but the frame rate is actually 5 frames a second. And considering the emulation has been pretty awesome so far on this collection, I'm going to assume that this is just like the native frame rate. Ugh, okay. Well, we got machine gun. Oh, we can slow. Oh, fuck. We can slow our chopper down. But, and we have machine gun, and that's kind of it. Oh, we got an auto mod. Allow that. Yeah, who gives a shit? Oh, yep. I'm, like, managing my chat while I'm playing this game. I'm not terribly invested in this. This is kind of just a standard fare shooter, isn't it? Rescue levels of the Pilot Wings SNES games, Gungnir says. Yeah, I mean, different camera angle, but yeah, relatively similar. Makes me want to play Ace Combat, Zephyrium says. Oh, man. Could I please get, like, an Ace Combat VR? Because that would make me the happiest motherfucker. I would get, like, a badass flight stick and... Oh! Yes, please. I love... well, okay, I used to love Ace Combat. I haven't played it since the PS2. But those were some dope games, for sure. Okay, so, yeah, we're just fighting a jabroni here. It's a shooter. Kind of an odd addition to the collection, I guess. Maybe some people have a lot of enjoyment out of this. I'm kind of not really feeling it. It's an average shooter, in my humble opinion. But again, my opinions don't really mean shit. They are doing Zone of the Enders VR, as Ethereum says. Yeah, I don't know a lot about that. I haven't looked into it because I don't want to get too much of a boner about it. I've played a good amount of Zone of the Enders 1, and by good amount I mean I beat it on the PS2, and then I played a little bit of the HD remake on 360. And then I can't recall if I beat Zone of the Enders 2 on PS2. I don't really remember that one. But yeah, Zone of the Enders VR, it might be amazing. I hope it is. It's only for second runner, but it looks cool. Cool. Yeah, I might have to look into that. This game, I'm not invested in this. We're just going to shut it down. It was okay. It was an average shooter with a 5 frames per second. Second runner's amazing when you get the teleport abilities, Ethereum says. Yeah, I don't think I even have that on my PS2. Guys, I don't have either Zone of the Enders. What am I doing? I only have the HD collection now. That's just embarrassing. I must have gotten rid of it at some point. Yeah, I had this brief stint where I used to just trade in games all the time. And I kind of hate myself for it, because now I hoard games, and I have a ton of games. And it makes me insanely happy. But yeah, I must have gotten rid of those. That actually makes me a little sad. A little bit sad right now. Alright, what else we got? Virtual Fighter 2. I used to play Virtual Fighter on my Sega Saturn. And at the time, it was pretty amazing. I can only imagine that on the Genesis, it's kind of shite. I feel like we're in for a shite game here. Let's see. I love Lau. He was the chef, right? Yeah, he's a chef. And he's badass. We have... I can't remember if any of these characters are new. Okay, I remember Akira, Pai, Lau. Wolf was in the original. Jeffrey, I think, was in the original. I don't really... Okay, I guess I'll just go fuck myself. We're playing as Cage. Oh, so this is interesting. It's not 3D. We're going back to sprites. Huh. Okay, then. But realistically, mechanically, it looks the same. It appears we can ring out, which you could do in the original. And obviously, it's just standard fare fighter game. Oh, and they even kept in the fucking moon jumps that Virtual Fighter had. Wow, yeah, you jump really high in these games. And I don't know why. Perhaps I'll die. Oh! See, that's what happens. You could be at full fucking health like I was. Well, almost. But if you step out or get knocked out, you're just boned. It's probably, well, not even probably. It's definitely for the better that they decided to go with sprites. Because trying to play this in 3D, I'm imagining it would have a juicy 2 frames per second on the Genesis. Hmm. Oh, yeah, I remember Sarah. Yeah. again, it's pretty standard fighting game. There's probably special moves. I don't know how to do them. You can block. That's kind of special. Hold the A button. You don't hold back. Hold a button. So that's like one-third of your controller real estate is dedicated to blocking. Yavu! What the fuck are you saying to me, Sarah? Oh, bitch! Yeah, getting knocked out. Out of nowhere! She had a family! Yeah, ring out. One of the things I like to do in Virtual Fighter was, like, ring out and win the match, and then just, like, I'm pretty sure it was in the original Virtual Fighter, but then you could just, like, keep fucking them up, like, even though you already won. I don't think I'm misremembering that. I remember doing that. Yeah, I used to play as that fucking chef in the Sega Saturn version and just wreck some ass. And by wreck some ass, I mean I probably got my ass kicked and I was a child and thought I was a badass. Yeah, Cage is the shit. And here we got Opie here. Ooh, Opie coming at me. Man, I wish. I wish I knew some fucking combos. That's what I wish. Get kicked, bitch. Ooh! Yeah, we're not able to keep up with these fights anymore. As you can see, the AI has improved substantially already. Oh, she's so happy! I don't blame you, you just beat the shit out of a ninja lady. You are definitely a badass. God, one hit did like a fifth of my health. Damn, girl! I mean, I know I'm just button mashing, but oh shit! Yeah, we're done. Oh, wait, we got a chance. Oh, you dumb lady, what are you doing? She just backed up. And remember, we're playing the PS4 Sega Collection here. So we can do fancy stuff like this. Do like this, yeah. Check that out, we can rewind if we want to. It's really seamless. Gotta say. So far, so good. I'm really enjoying this collection. Cheat hacks! Don't worry, we still got our ass kicked. Zephyrium. Ooh, that laugh gets my my blood boiling, doesn't it? You should really stop blocking my punches with your face. Damn. Alright, so that game wasn't as bad as I thought it was gonna be, because it wasn't 3D. So, that's good. That is real good, actually. Check out my dope bed sheets, by the way. Nice. Alright. I'm gonna take, like, a quick 1 minute break here. Got all this shit filling up my bladder. And, yeah, pick out a game, would ya? Let's see if we can't, decide what we're gonna do next. Okay. Sorry about that. So, what to do? What to do? How about... one of my favorite Genesis games. We'll take a look at it. I'll try not to play too much of it. Again, this is like one of my first Let's Plays that I've done. I don't recommend watching it. It's not good. But it is one that I did, regardless. Comics Zone. That's what I'm talking about. So, we got like an amazing beat-em-up here. Plot is not relevant right now. We're just checking shit out. Actually, can I... Hold on. What are my controller settings? Oh, beautiful. Okay. So, with certain games that are compatible, like Comic Zone, they had a 6-button Sega Genesis controller. And yeah, it's compatible with that here. So, R1 is going to do our first slot. And then triangle does our middle slot, and L1 does our right slot. Nice. Because, yeah, otherwise if you're playing this game with a 3-button controller, you had to hit, I think it was the C button, to manage your inventory and then, like, use items. And it was just a pain in the ass. But yeah, this was just amazing. And yeah, Moonsidian says he remembers this game being hard as fuck, and you are absolutely correct. Your health, like, didn't replenish except between chapters. So, like, if you're going between levels, your health would still be fucked. And the only way you could restore health is by drinking that little thing I have in the middle of my inventory, those little bottles. You could earn continues with points. Otherwise, you don't have any continues. So, yeah, one death, one life, and you're just fucking done. And also, destroying shit like barrels, like that barrel I destroyed, will actually hurt you just a little bit, because, you know, you're punching like solid steel. So it's gonna hurt a little. So yeah, you have some health management there when it comes to destroying items. It's just, it's fucking hard. Let's just put it that way. This game's ridiculously hard. God, get out of there, roadkill. Come on. Let's go ahead and drop our knife. Yeah, not worried about that. By drop on her knife, I mean I'll throw the fucking knife at the rat. Okay, and you can operate levers. Wow. Well, I say that. Can I do it? There we go. Make sure there's no bullshit. We're good. When it comes to destroying drums, you kind of want to push into them like this and then attack. And you can destroy them with the least amount of effort possible with just one hit. Which I think costs you the least amount of health. Ah, you dick. I'm not near as good at this game as I remember. So, roadkill, let's see if there's any items here. Oh yeah, look at that. Occasionally we'll find hidden items. Really handy little rat to have around. You can get yourself some healing items, etc. throughout the game. If you just set them loose. And here we got Striggle. Strigil? Ugh. Comic Zone, you are way too good. The downside to this game is it is, like, terribly fucking short. Like, if you know what you're doing, it's gonna take you, like, what, an hour? If that? Like, it's so short. Yeah, biggest downside to this game. So, here is a problem. Switch is way too high, and if you look down, flaming barrels, either way you're gonna get fucked up. But if you go ahead and just push this here... Bada bing, and then we're gonna get off this lever and blow the shit out of those. Nice. Ooh, Comic Zone, you're so satisfying. And it's running really well, too. Ooh, nice dodge. So, this guy, I like to get right up against these fucking things and just kick his ass right into the pit. It's so good. Ugh. Alright, come here, you bitch. This thing's such a pain in the ass. He does not like to move out of that spot. Alright, so this jump has killed me like so many times. Woo, we made it.
Oh yeah.
What the fuck was that? And yeah, when that superhero meter fills up, that's the end of the game. So as you can see, we've already got that much through the game. Yeah, really short shit. So if you have roadkill here, find a little item, which is some dynamite. This door will actually fuck your health up. It is reinforced and a pain in the ass. I already have some dynamite, so we're good. But yeah, that'll get you in there. No damage necessary. Weird stuff. And these guys just uppercut, what, twice? Yeah, two times. If you pussyfoot around too much, they're going to drop an enemy, and it's just going to be really obnoxious. The process has started. All right, Struggle. I like to kick this guy if I can. Right into that fucking fan and just drop him really easily. It's also just really satisfying. All right, so this fan will do a lot of damage to you if you hit it while it's on. But if we get our handy dandy rat, yeah, I'll just turn those off for us, no problem. Now we can do this. Also, I'm kind of talking like this is a Let's Play, I apologize. I just am really into this game. Is there a hidden item here? No. Oh, no, okay. Let's just get rid of this fan, make sure we're not in the fuck zone. We're good. Yeah, aerial assault. I don't remember the ideal path to go. You get a split branch here. We'll probably take the upper left path. Seems reasonable. Whoops. Nice. Alright. There we go. We got a mortise down there. More dynamite. Look at this. This game's feeding me the dynamite. I think I could just fucking do this, right? Yeah, go fuck yourself. So good. Oh, shit. Alright, this looks like a hidden item zone. But it is not. Okay. Another really nice thing about roadkill is that there's certain enemies that are like Amazon women. And they're just like deathly afraid of rats. So if you unleash roadkill on them, they'll just fuck right off. And otherwise, they're like really dangerous, so it's nice to have that option. Yeah, get these dicks out of here. And as you can see, I have my health potion here, and we really haven't found any other health potions. And again, you don't restore health in between the levels there, just the chapters. So, if you're new to this game and you're having a hard time, you're not gonna make it this far. it's really brutal. But these guys are cake. All you have to do is just button mash them. Just make sure you button mash them as soon as they spawn. Because yeah, they will, yeah, as you see there, I didn't kill that guy. They will kind of overwhelm you a little bit. They like to do dash attacks with their horns. That guy's doing it there. So just make sure you dispatch them really quickly. Also, I kind of just noticed that I'm still playing Comic Zone. Whoops. We're supposed to be checking out a lot of other games. Oh yeah, get fucked. Dodge those dash attacks. They do some good damage. So, if you manage to bring roadkill with you here, drink this, you can actually get another health potion. If you brought the rat with you. Otherwise, no, you don't get any health items, because fuck you. That's how this game operates. Mmm. Alright, pardon me, need a drink there. So here's the chapter 1 boss. And this thing's a prick, but if you manage to spook it upwards, like this, you can roll. Oh god, alright, let's try it again. You can cheese this boss pretty easily. Get under, get on the barrel, he ignites the barrel, and then you just push this motherfucker right under him. Look at that. Oh my god, you're fired! Alright, Donald Trump in the house again.
Oh yeah, boy. Boy.
Fuck, I love comic. Whoa, what was that? Right analog stick. What the fuck? Look at that, quick saves. Oh, that's cool. Very nice. Learned more about the PS4 version. Alright, let's get the fuck out of Comic Zone. I could seriously just play that game so much. I love it. Oh, yeah, just... cool. Cool frame there. There, Sketch. Just sniffing your shoe. Yeah. Big in the streets. Yeah, I'm in this freezing fucking cold. Let me take my shoe off real quick. What a dope. Okay. So what's next, guys? What's next? What do we want to see? Oof. Sonic. You know, Sonic's always classic. Sonic 3D Blast. Did not play that on the Genesis. Again, I played that on the Sega Saturn. Which I think the only difference really is the bonus levels. I could be wrong, but I know the Saturn had some fucking great bonus levels. And yeah, I don't think the Genesis... I think it was very different on the Genesis. We have... What is Monster Lair? This is one of my favorite Genesis games, Monster World. Let me see what Monster Lair is. This is probably like a... one of those auto-scrolling versions, right? Yeah. Okay. One or two players start. So yeah, very different than the game I'm so fond of. It's an auto scroll. You have to keep your food meter up or set your health. This is very vague to me. Barely have played these games. You can see like the environments are kind of similar, you know. It's literally Adventure Island. Is what I'm trying to say. yeah, literally. Adventure Island. And we got the missile tank. I feel like we're playing that randomizer again. Damn, dude. Missiles out of your sword. Get some onion rings, get some carrots. Don't want to fall in the water. Oh, it's like a twin shot here. Nice. Get the special sperm cannon. Yep, good, good. Lots of kiwis. Oh, yep. There you go, right into the water. And look, it's a dragon, yeah! So yeah, it's a side-scrolling shooter. It's cool. Very different than its counterpart that I played, which I'll show you just very briefly, but I'm gonna try not to get into it. So this game, it was just a random rental for me, and I fell in love. Once a peaceful region, yeah, shattered by invading monsters, a young man named Shion vowed to defeat him. Again, I did a let's play of this one, and again, I don't recommend it, but I did do an LP of it. So yeah, it's actually just an RPG. You get heart containers, you get gold, you get equipment. Really, really solid game. Great graphics, great music. I love this game. And I haven't played any of the really recent Monster World games. I don't know what's wrong with me. I just haven't. This is kind of the only one I ever really played. Oh, it's so good. This Ryu-looking motherfucker. We should have, like, what, a shop in here, right? Yeah, you can get you some upgraded boots. Leather boots. Yeah, you can upgrade various stats, like your speed. Which will actually increase your character's movement speed, you know, attack, defense, you earn magic, all sorts of stuff. Yeah, Asamoya asking about the Switch version. Yeah, there's like a newer one coming out on the Switch, but again, I don't know why, I just haven't looked into them. Something wrong with my brain, I think. Because they're just super fun. At least this one is. Alright, anyway, I'm not actually going to play this, I just want to show it off real quick. So, what else do we have? Light Crusader. No idea what this game is. I'm going to play some that I just don't know what they are. Oh, it's a treasure game. Really? Okay. You've got my attention. Light Crusader. Copy file? What? Delete file? What are you talking about?
I shall have my revenge for what they have all done to me. I shall never forgive them.
He looks not so angry though, doesn't he? Oh shit. What is this? Okay. This is a cool plot and all, but yeah, it's actually a cutscene. No disrespect to like any big fans of this game, but I kind of just want to see what the gameplay is like. It so far it looks pretty impressive. Sorry, I know this is like really obnoxious. Whoa, look at this. Townspeople seem to be frightened of something. David, I'm pleased to see you. You've traveled a great distance, as evident by your just, like, breathing heavily. Holy shit, man. Take a breath. Happening in Green Row, King Whedon began to tell me the most amazing story. A lot of people have been disappearing recently. Townspeople fear some magic spell may have been cast. You're such a gifted swordsman, Sir David. Please, search for the missing people. I certainly will. Yep, okay, so full range of movement here. Text boxes are really nice. You can move while people are talking to you. Jump. Okay. Huh. I might have to look into this one. This looks fucking fascinating. Graphically amazing. Music sounds really good. Very, very interesting. Weapon shop, touch whatever you like. Oh my! Are you coming on to me there, Mr. Vendor? Relayer is 1500 GP.
I need more GP.
No, a bit stingy, aren't you? So if you want to shop, you just gotta fucking jump on the items. Oh shit! Nobody puts Vendor in the corner. Wow, nice. What is this magical game that I've literally never heard anyone talk about? It's a puzzle to me. I'm still here, aren't I? Yeah. What? What about our menus here? Inventory, menu music here. We got our equipment screen. Wow, look at this. Yeah, Moon Science is pretty interesting. I agree. Mode, damage number, window on, item auto use, magic. Wow, look at this map. What the hell? This is cool. Huh. These cows, holy shit. Oh no, don't attack the cows. Oops, I don't remember how to fucking communicate with people. I like that it says oops when you fuck around with your sword. Also, yeah, here we go, game of the year all year. Yeah, he doesn't like that shit. Ooh, spoopy graveyard. Ooh, this music's good. And look, it actually has like sound effects when I'm like connecting with the tombstones. Huh. This is a Genesis game. Really. Maybe it was a pretty late one. I wonder. There's an inn here. Oh! Rewind. Whoops. Sorry about that. What do you got there, lady? Oops. Have you seen my child? He's nowhere to be found. Alright, how do I get out of this town? I'm a little intrigued as to see how combat works. But I don't know if I'm going to be able to leave this town easily. Fuck, it's like hard to talk to people. Mommy and Daddy are gone! How do we get out of this town? yeah, there's no one here, is there? My next door neighbor disappeared 3 days ago. Vanished, just vanished. Scary, isn't it? I'm like slowly walking away as he's talking to me. Come to think of it, I haven't seen Cullen recently. It's a lot of my interactions at work, like people talking to me and I'm just taking like one step at a time as they're trying to say stuff. Are you gonna buy something? Nah, man, I'm good. Welcome. Listen to me, I saw it. A human form was prowling about in the middle of the night in the graveyard. And it wasn't alone, there were 5 or 6 of them. What do you think they were up to? My missus went off somewhere and never came back. She must have been spirited away. Never watching that movie. I'd rather not cry all the time. Well then, so there's like shit in the graveyard. Maybe we should see if we can stay at the inn until night? I don't know, I'm like completely at a loss here. I know it's my own fault, I haven't been paying attention to the plot. Would you like to hear my music? You'd love to, wouldn't you? You will? Listen then. Look how massive! Jesus! What the fuck is wrong with you? Stop! Oh fuck! I can't move, by the way. Oh, I like that little BAM! Right at the end. Amazing. Thank you. Fuck! What is this game? Oh god. Ah, my camera! What is. Look at the screen and then those eyeballs in the background. Whoa! People disappear, but works of art remain. Stop wasting my time. What the fuck is going on here? Jesus. I gotta get out of this hell. This is where people go when they die. Let's check out the inn. This is a cool fucking game, and I haven't even done anything here. Asamoya with the demon wall reference, yep. Why on earth did I ever come to this town? I'm kind of wondering that myself. Welcome to Ted's Inn. You have 200 GP. It's 10 GP per night. Would you like to stay? No. Ah, well. Hold on, I like this. It's 10 GP per night? Like she's asking me? No, actually, it's free every night, remember? And what is all this shit? Oh, so we get some spells, too. Cool. See, even the inn has stuff to sell. I wanna go back to that creepy graveyard. It's Spoop Town. Hope my cows don't get kidnapped. Ooh, nice water graphics, too. This is a pretty nifty looking game, is it not? Have to check that out later. That is really cool. What the hell was the name of this? Hold up. Let's get out of here. It did save, right? Yeah, we're good. This is... I can't remember the name of it. Light Crusader. Huh. Yeah, I'll have to look into that. That seemed really, really cool. And a treasure game, no less. Beyond Oasis. Biohazard Battle. What is this? Don't know this one either.
Oof, Sega, yeah!
One play, two play options. Yep, nice. Okay, I'm getting some kind of flashbacks here to some trash I hope I don't piss anyone off saying that. I don't know if I'm remembering right. Yeah, this is a weird ass shooter, isn't it? Though I don't think this is the trash I was thinking of. No, this isn't the trash. I was thinking of different trash. So this is a shooter. Like Biohazard. Oh, the music is great. Oh, it's weird. Okay, the greens are good. I was like trying to avoid it. Oh god. So I think we want to stick with the same colors to like, oh wow, nice, Alan. To like power up our beams. But we can charge it, as you can see. That's cool. Just a creepy fucking shooter where you're fighting like biological enemies, like Abadox kinda on NES. Oh yeah, fuck it. We'll just grab every one of these. Why not? Pretty cool though, I'm digging the music, I gotta say. It's creepy. Oh, I'm liking this shot. Nice. Oh, fuck. So yeah, cool shooter. I mean, not a lot to talk about there. Very cool shooter. E-SWAT. Anyone know what E-SWAT is? City Under Siege. Or S-WIT. Oh, look at this RoboCop motherfucker. E-SWAT. Thank you for the voice. Now I know how to pronounce it. Jesus, how do I start this game?
E-SWAT.
Thank you. A select, B attack, C jump. Sephirium says this looks familiar. Okay. Maybe you know something about it. Alright.
First mission start.
Guard the Silent City. Okay, I did not expect this kind of game, but admittedly, I don't really know what I was expecting. So, it's a shoot game. With like a like weapon meter on the bottom. I'm assuming we're gonna collect power-ups and unlock different abilities, or weird game, isn't it? Oh shit! I just shot a bullet out of the air with a bullet. I am king badass. Also, I just took a little bit of damage. Getting someone trying to sweep the leg here. Watch out for these mortar motherfuckers. Oh! An L up! I need that. That's life up, right? Yeah, alright, got our health back. Nice. Oh, go fuck yourself with that. Come on. I was like trying to shoot him midair. Not happening. Okay, good. We made it. Yeah, I definitely can't make that jump. Let's try going around here, I guess. Can I jump? Ah, I can, nice. Is it like Sunset Riders? Yeah, actually it is. I have to like hold up and jump. And I can go up to like higher platforms. Nice. Sometimes it helps having played like a bunch of other fucking games. Alright, here we go. Made it, nice. The fucking slide kick though gets me every time, it seems. Oi. What is this, machine gun? M? What does M stand for? Whatever M stands for, it gave me full health. Oh, we got a boss! Oh shit, it's a chopper! All I have is a dinky-ass pistol. This is kind of a problem. Yep, there we go. Starting to attack. I don't know, this is a cool game. I can get behind this. Woo, shit!
Get to the chopper!
Moonside. Moonsidian says, M stands for M full heal, or M full heal. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, God. Shit. Oh, I'm getting properly hosed here, which, I mean, honestly should be happening. I'm fighting a fucking helicopter. I did not take damage there. Okay. Son, where are you? Ah! Oh, okay, we gotta continue, but looks like the boss fight starts over. Ooh! You need to do this shit in one run. Oh, you cock! Give me a machine gun! Yeah, here's where I need to dish it out. So I proceeded to like shoot him twice and do nothing. Wow. Replace this fucking guy with a giant bee and we have Mega Man X. There he is. Oh shit. Oh, I hit him a little bit. Oh, yeah, you mother. Take it. Am I gonna get a fucking weapon power up like, Journey to Silius? Is that what's gonna happen? Okay, I'm a chief now, and look, we have to fight an ogre or something. Cool. Second mission start. Well, this is a cool game. I don't really know how you get other weapons or power-ups, but it's cool. Oh, get in! What do you mean, in? Oh, shit, we got layering effects. Oh, fancy. Slow down. Yeah, I don't really see any of the buttons doing anything else. Cool. Neat game. Not about to complain about that. Go and save for no reason. So let's do something different real quick. We've been checking out just random games. What's going on here? Online multiplayer. So it has matchmaking, okay? What the fuck is this? Matchmaking. Is it just pick a random game? Let's try it out. I'm hitting the cross button. It doesn't seem to be working. Square, also not doing anything. Weird. Oh. You can keep playing while you wait. Unsaved data will be lost on connection. Well, that's fancy, isn't it? So while I'm trying to connect via matchmaking, I can just fuck around with whatever I want. Also, what's that sticker on the side of my speaker there? Oh, heard a noise. Searching for players, nice. It's a little laggy, but it seems like it's functioning. I kind of want to just see what happens here. If it pairs me with someone in Toe Jam, that's going to be a problem because I might just have to play Toe Jam for like 3 hours. Yeah, is it Knuckles? Asamoya asks. Asamoya. Is it Knuckles? It's like real hard to tell. It's a weird angle there. Is it Rouge the Bat? Oh, God. VHS tapes, Sega Genesis. This is the kind of fucking TV I was talking about. You're trying to play Crackdown on this fucking TV, so you're looking at the bottom left of the screen, which is like a couple inches of screen real estate to watch your character. Yeah, kind of a problem. Oh, man. I have a 32-inch... tube TV for retro games, but I also need like a little TV like this guy for old time's sakes. Oh, so good. Well, matchmaking is kind of taking a million years, isn't it? You know what? Let's just put in another game and we will no doubt abruptly be kicked. So for those of you that haven't seen Robotnik's Mean Beat Machine, we'll show it off real quick. I hate this fucking game with a fat passion. Sega. Robotnik! Yas, there he is, that ugly motherfucker. Jesus. So, we have a scenario, we already have a Puyo on the screen. And, yeah, but no, they're beans. It's Robotnik's beans. Beans, beans, let me give you a hand or two. What? I've to prepare Dr. Robotnik a beautiful... You're talking too fast, my man. Come to arms, my beauties. And yeah, it's Puyo. Even have the fucking Puyo character on the bottom next to the score. They didn't even try and, like, change that sprite. Oh, that's great. But yeah, I hate this game. I suck an eternal ass at Puyo. So yeah, it's not that it's a bad game. I'm sure it's decent. But I can't judge it because I suck at it and I hate it. So yeah, that's that, huh? Oh, cool, and like the little online multiplayer, it's still trying there on the top. That's cool. I don't know why we're not finding anyone. Surely there's more people playing this fucking game. It like just came out. No, maybe not, I don't know. Puyo. Puyo a Puyo. You know, I can't stand this. We're getting out of here. Jeebus Christ. That game, it just triggers me so bad. I tried quite a bit to get a high score on that, because you had to do something like that to unlock a game on the 360 Genesis collection. Super Thunderblade. Did I play this? What is this? Moonside, and one main thing I remember about this is the song, and you think multiplayer, really fucking fat. Was there? Oh, yeah, I played. This is the Hong Kong, whatever the fuck. Weird game. Yeah, I played that. Had like a really fast multiplayer theme, is that right? And speaking of really fast multiplayer, I wish this worked. It appears like it just doesn't work, doesn't it? Do I need to filter the games, or? No, they're like all gravy. Oh yes, Toe Jam. Just the fact that you could play Toe Jam online multiplayer makes this whole thing fucking worth it, in my personal opinion. That is an amazing, amazing thingy. Okay, fine, we'll check out a little Toe Jam. I keep talking about it. I just need to try and control myself here. Whoa! There's that noise again. Oh, it's so good! Alright, wait, hold up. Let's try something real quick. Full screen. Let's see what this... Oh, wait, no. That just makes it go back here. I was gonna see if there were some more display options. Actually, I know there are. Let's check this out. Where was it? Here? Bilinear EPX creates 4x more pixels based on the original artwork. That sounds interesting. Smooths diagonal lines and curves. Anti-alias is the output. Uses two-stage set of interpolation. Can't pronounce that word, apparently. Scan lines, mirror mode, start and full screen. Stretched. Oh, we could stretch it if we wanted to. Flip screen horizontally. Why? Disable sprite limit. Whoa! Disable the sprite limit. Override some console rendering limitations. Really? Oh, and here's what I was thinking about. We can change the border. Oh, fuck yeah, dude. We got wood, we got Sonic, streets, stripes, black, jazz. Oh, yeah, baby. Checkers. Well, we gotta go with jazz. We're gonna be playing a little bit of Toe Jams. Let's try out this EPX mode. I don't really know what I'm doing with the graphic settings, so yeah, let's try it out. Oh, I love Toe Jam so much. Let's try it out. Random world, let's go. Graphics look pretty decent. I can see a little bit of change with the emulation, but it's not bad. Okay, so who remembers what we try and do on level 1? Does anyone? What you want to do, that jazz board. Yeah, Moonsidian's complimenting the border. The border's fantastic. I love it. Really top quality shit. This is a good collection, guys. For $30, I am recommending this. This definitely has my recommendation. And I know you've already bought it a million times, so I guess if you already have it, probably not worth it, but it's fucking cool. I like this. Gungnir reminds me of those old styrofoam cups. Yes. So here's what you do on level 1, Toe Jam, at least what I do. We try and get some rocket skates, because there's a secret level in level 1. So yeah, go to our inventory, and we got a fucking mole. No, we do not want that. Try this out, we got just some food. Yeah, these bouncy spring shoes aren't gonna help, and last but not least, rose bushes, not gonna help. You can use either an inner tube or rocket skates to get to the secret level. And that mole is fucking miserable because he jostles you and makes you drop presents. Oh, I want to play Toe Jam. Holy shit. Music is way too good. It even has like a bonus mode in the main menu where you can fucking make your own music. So good. Mailboxes are really nice right now. Later on, it's possible to get mimic mailboxes, which are fucking horrifying. Let's try out real quick. See what else we got. Diagonal lines of curves, anti-aliasing. Let's try out some anti-aliasing here. See what we got. Whoops, full screen. Ooh, not as big of a fan on this one. A little too... What's the word I'm looking for? It's just too blended for me. Don't like that one. Change it back real quick. Waste some time. Whoa! Buttons, please. What about this guy? Scan lines for more authentic... Oh, no, we don't want scan lines. Similar to this... Better handling complex patterns. So this is similar to the one we were just using. Let's see if it's any better for us. I don't hate it. It's really smooth, you know. If you're not a big fan of pixels, it's pretty fucking smooth. Oh my god, this phone. Alright, we want to avoid this jackass. We have the rose bush ability right now from one of our presents, which just simply lays a damaging rose bush in the way. And also, there's not a ship piece here, so I don't really know why I'm exploring. Well, no, I kind of do. You want to explore around because every tile you uncover on the map is going to give you points, and these points are going to level you up, increase your health, etc., etc. Good shit will happen. Yeah. Oh, hey, Zerferium, thank you. But yeah, so exploring gives you points, using presents gives you points, killing enemies. I'm gonna regret going this way though. This is a fucking dead end if ever I saw one. Jeebus. Well done, Toe Jam. And you know what, since we're not actually playing this game too seriously, I could just use some super high tops. You start off with four of these bad boys. If you're playing co-op, you only have two. It's split between you. And just let you run fast. They're nice. Gotta be careful. Normally, if you walk to a ledge, you kind of do this like, whoa! And like, you almost fall off. But if you're fucking running, you just jump. Like the Dickens. So yeah, you gotta be a little careful. And walking on roads, you get a little bit of a speed boost. So it behooves you to stay on those. If you can. Grab this present real quick. And some fucking fries. Yes, sir. Oh, yeah, baby. Look at this. That's what I'm talking about. Pancakes, burgers. Oh! Me and my wife actually completed this game together. We played all the way through a randomized run, and we got to the end. We beat it together. It was really fucking cool, honestly. The game gets so brutal towards the end, so yeah, it was really satisfying. We have a few more presents that we don't know what they are. So real quickly, we're gonna check it out. We're looking for rocket skates. or an inner tube. Fudge Sunday. Fuck your ass with the randomizer. God damn. So that's the randomizer. There's one of those in the game, and all the presents that you've identified, they just get randomized, so it fucking sucks. And we also have a thundercloud, which is murdering my ass. Oh god, yeah, bad RNG, holy shit. So I guess the online multiplayer is just broken, huh? It seems like it is. Like, nothing is connecting. And I am online. I made sure I'm on the Wi-Fi. Oh well. Oh, ship piece here. Yeah, you want to keep an eye out for that. And yeah, we got some yucky fungus, which hurt us because it's a disgusting item, but it did give us enough points to become a doofus. So even picking up shitty items can actually give you a little bit of an advantage. You just gotta be careful. Alright, what do we got? Try this out. We got a door. Just randomly teleports you around. And hula girls! Some freakazoid shit. Oh, yeah. Hula girls! Good stuff. I keep opening the map. I gotta get this control scheme down. I apologize for all that shit. This game just has massive quantities of charm, massive quantities of replay value. It's so solid. So fucking solid. And also the second one. A lot of people didn't like it as much. And, you know, I don't necessarily blame them, but it's still really solid. It's a great game. Also, I have the shitty filter still on. Can we do something about that real quick? How about, blurring together? No, I kind of like the EPX. Yeah, that one didn't bother me as much. Let's try that out. A little bit longer. Here we go. Great intro. I don't understand it either. But yeah, it's a platformer. Look at that shit. Whoop, whoop, whoop. Yeah, side-scrolling platformer. Co-op. You can play at the same time with your friends.
Awesome.
Great graphics. Music is, like, top-notch. Oh shit, that's the
Hyperfunk Zone.
Yes. Listen to that voice.
Yes.
Fuck this bonus level, by the way. You gotta avoid those portals or you just get, like, warped out. But yeah, little kid mode. You got bab mode if you want. Just a toe jam for now, please. But yeah, side scroller. You got these jars. You gotta capture all the humans that are hidden around the levels. And then you just exit the level. And that's that. You can shake trees like you're fucking playing Animal Crossing. Yeah. Just really good game. Mainly for the music. Holy shit, the music is top notch. It's a bit of a departure from the first. So that's why a lot of people don't necessarily like it as much. I guess I'm kind of in that boat. I much prefer the original when it comes to gameplay, but it's still really good. Alright. And yeah, watch out for garbage, because that shit will mess you up. Oh yeah, see, we got like these spongy brains here. A lot of these in the different levels. And you can do tricks and shit. Super jars, trap humans in one hit. Nice. Almost got hit by that garbage. Oh shit, there he is! Yep, and then you just capture him, you pick him up. There you go. That's essentially the gameplay in a nutshell. Yeah, great addition to the collection. I guess I'm just gonna turn this fucking trash off. Does not seem to be working. Yep. Oh well, sorry. You can invite a friend though. If any of you guys ever get this game and want to fuck around, I don't know, maybe. If I feel like it. If I have time, realistically. because I never have any time nowadays. So columns 1 and 3. Not very familiar with these, because I don't really do puzzle games, if you couldn't tell by Meme Beam Machine. But I'm pretty sure that I know someone that would appreciate me looking at these, so let's take a look real quick at columns 3. Definitely not Tetris! The revenge of columns. What the fuck did we do to columns that they need revenge on us? Let's try the 1P mode. Wow, we have a plot. We definitely have a plot, don't we? Select the entrance. Well, I want to enter the practice hole. So let's do the practice hole. Wow, look at that hole.
Who are you?
And what is this? I actually don't know what I'm playing right now. I just know it's a puzzle. So we connect the gemeralds here. And if we connect 3, maybe something happens? Yeah, okay, I thought it was maybe that kind of shit. So yeah, it's one of those connect 3 kind of games. Everything shuffles downwards. I'm sure you could like chain your infinity stones there and do some damage if you wanted. It's just not my cup of tea, is all. Seems pretty cool though. If you wanted a good puzzle game on the Genesis, I bet this was your jam, for sure. And what do we have? We have like a meter. Like 15 versus 3, 5 versus 1. I'm not sure if it's like an endurance, if we need to like reach a certain goal or something. Oh shit! You can go diagonal, that's cool. I do appreciate that. Alright, well, that's columns. If you like puzzles, go for it. Again, part of the collection there. Nice. I do really appreciate that you don't actually need to unlock anything in this collection. It's just kind of like, here you go. Play them all. Like, seriously. Decap Attack, that's a weird game. That is definitely a weird game. Oh, man. Cool shit. Alex Kidd and the Enchanted Castle. I didn't really play this. Didn't really play Kid Chameleon. Kid Chameleon is, like, the platformer where you just, like, change into different, like, costumes and shit, right? Or not costumes, but just, like, different forms. Check out that fucking title screen. That's fantastic. Yeah, you're in, like, some kind of VR game? Oh, yeah, check out this bad motherfucker. So yeah, base form, you can just like jump on enemies to do some damage. But I think in one of these guys here, controls are a little weird though. Right here? Huh? Somewhere around here we can get a power up and then things get a little bit different. Oh god, how do you... Is it like Mario 2? Do I need to charge it? No? Well, I bet I could jump off this jackass if I wanted to. Oh, yeah, that's good.
Oh, yeah.
There it is. Get, like, some knight armor, and it changes. We now have 5 health instead of 2, and now we can, like, smash open the bricks instead of just bouncing into them. And each form has, like, different abilities, yada, yada, yada. You get the gist of it. Pretty neat game, but I'm just, I don't know, not too familiar with it. Never really gave it a shot, not when I played as a kid. I can definitely see the appeal to it though. Cool platformer for your Genesis. Oh, look at that short level, come on. Oh, we have to touch the flag, excuse me. What was I thinking? You know what this collection doesn't have though? Pugsy. Ugh. Like one of my favorite Sega games. Come on. Yeah, get the P! Yes! Now we're a samurai. So we have less health, but we have this dope fucking sword. Yeah. And I'm almost dead already. Nice! Moon Sidian, says, main thing I remember about this game is you get super lost. Really? Like, there's just some massive levels, huh? I did not know that. Oh, fuck. I'm getting cool iframes, by the way, in this game. I'm getting murdered. I am way too noobish to be playing this. Oh! The greens. They got me. Yeah, I didn't realize this was one of those get lost kind of games. Why are there two samurai helmets here, anyway? Alright, let's not fuck around with the acid here. Remember, the acid is more afraid of you than you are of it. There you go. Oh yeah. Get katana'd. Nice. Oh! Shit! Oh god, how do you get all the way up there? It's like some shit that's really high up in this game. I don't know how to get. Ooh, will that replenish my health? That's what I want to know. Yes, it will. Sweet. Whoa! Projectiles. Yeah, you have no iframes in this game, so just good luck with that shit. I don't know, control feels a little floaty to me. I couldn't tell if it's just the PS4 or if it's just the game. Probably the game, if I had to guess. Whoa, yellow. Hello. Yellow! This is yellow as shit. Oh god, yeah. Did I just say die? Well, welcome to die. Thank you, Blue Lake Woods. You were kind of annoying, let's be honest. What about Alex Kidd? Wasn't this like the mascot character for a little bit? Or am I just totally thinking of something else? So we got Alex, we got like some rock, paper, scissors going on in the background. Jesus Christ, and the Enchanted Castle. Hold on, let me change these settings back. They're cool and all, but I want to get the original look here with the pixel scaling, if we can. Alright, here we go. Oh shit, look at that, guys. You can play like you're actually looking at a CRT. That's kind of neat. I appreciate that. There we go. Rookie Town. And we got a rice ball. Oh god, this one feels... Wow, excuse the fuck out of me, I jumped on a car. I should have known better. So clearly, I'm just gonna punch it, right? Yeah, I learned my lesson. Don't jump on a car, just punch it. Much better. This one feels really floaty too, though. Beat me at the game, and I'll give you a gift of 50 Pokédollars. Will you bet your life? Shit, this got serious. Yes. Pick paper, rock, or scissors before the music stops. Ready. John Kenpone! Yeah, we got fucked. Not your lucky day, is it? So, Jonken wasn't translated, okay. This is really, really weird. What the fuck was that? Did I just break the ground? Why? Oh, shit! It's a jumping vampire! Okay. I'm just a little confused right now. And I'm a little dead right now. I'm digging the one-hit kills, they're really cool. Talk about surreal, holy shit. Fuck! Have a great night, Spherium. Thank you for watching. Appreciate you being here. And also, fuck this game. Not interested right now. I'm sure it's great, but yeah, not right now. Oh fuck, I forgot we had Bonanza Bros. Yes! Gotta get me some Bonanza Bros. Also, it's getting late as shit. I didn't realize how long I've been streaming. Wow. You can't punch a car, silly, Moonsidian says. Yeah, I know. So this is another game, I guess, kind of like Crackdown. Where if you're not playing co-op, fuck your video real estate. Because half your screen is just gonna be gone. Ask me why I like this game so much, I can't tell you. It's actually really not that great. But I like it. As you can see, just half the screen is saying, just play the fucking game, second player. Which is really obnoxious, honestly. So we gotta get all the loot. And how do I open doors? Jesus. You gotta get all the loot, and you just don't get caught or killed by the cops. That's really it. You have a time limit. You have a gun, but it's not like a kill gun. It's just a stun gun. You can also kill enemies with doors and get real strategic if you like. And also you can see the treasures kind of marked on the map there. So this cop is going to be a problem, but we're good. And one more for the road there, fucko. Nope. Now he's alerted the horde. By the horde, I mean fucking no one, apparently. Nice. Just going to stay in cover as much as possible. This is going to be a problem. But we got to get in there. Oh, yep. And when you die, he goes, shit! Not really, but it sounds like it, so I always imagine that. Shit! Oh, fuck your bullets. Come on. Really? Yeah, I haven't played this game in like 18 billion years, but for some reason, a lot of it sticks with me. Like I said, it's not good. I don't know why. Oh, get you a door, bitch. Yes. And how about one more for the fuck? Nope. But we shot him in the back, so we're good. So you get all the treasure. And there you go. That's the game. It's okay, I guess. It's a lot better when you do have that second player. But you can actually strategize. Like, oh, okay, I'll get these treasures. You know, you go over here. Or you can work together, like fucking over the guards. That sort of deal. Let's not step on the can like we're in Chrono Trigger. I like how a can would wake his ass up, but me shooting a bullet didn't immediately wake him. That was nice. Where the fuck am I, by the way? Are these enemies or just chefs? Okay, this is gonna be kind of sketch, but we're good. Music's pretty bitchin' in this game. yeah, no thank you. These guys don't have guns, but they do have batons, so they will get in melee range and try and jack it. I don't remember what those guys are. I just remember they take like 18 hits. Alright. Let's get the fuck back down here, please. Oh, you can jump on stairs. I did not know you could do that. Shit! Cool, game over, right? Oh, there it is. Like I said, it's decent. I have this weird nostalgia for it. Fucking Bonanza Bros. And I guess a few people liked it because they included it in this collection, didn't they? I love that you can just ruin people's lives with doors. It's so good. There was actually like a Game Center CX of this fucking game too. I don't know why, but there was. Maybe it has like a cult following? Sure, why not? Alright, can you just get over here and eat bullet, please? Oh, just go back to sleep? Okay, yeah, we're good. Jackass. Alright, we have one more treasure on the right. Let's just fuck off over here. Oh yeah, we're about to get hairy. Oh! Oh shit! That worked, okay. We just gotta get to the stairs. Oh! We're just about there, guys. I know you're really invested in this Banana Bros. Banana Bros? Yeah, I'm invested in the Banana Bros. This Bonanza Bros experience. Fuck. Game over. Oh, no. Alright, we got a few continues. So how do you handle these guys? You just have to sneak around back, yeah. There's no way to take them out with the shield. We're almost there. We got this. Alright, just keep playing with yourself, whatever you're doing. We got the treasure. Here we go. Epic conclusion. Yeah! Fuck yeah. Break through the wall. Oh, what a silly, silly game. Good shit. That's not even worth saving, to be honest. Bonanza Bros. Let's do one more. Just one more game. It's getting real late for me. I don't have work tomorrow. That's why I went ahead and just played a little bit later. Gunstar is really awesome, but surely you people know about that. Fantastic game. That would be fun to play online if the online feature worked. But unfortunately, it's being a dingleberry today, isn't it? Real unfortunate. Trophies. What do we get for trophies? I don't know if I've unlocked any because I have, like, notifications disabled. Trophies, and we got, like, challenges. Defeat the Crab Nabber using just the dagger. Look at that. So here's a cool feature. Phantasy Star. Asamoya is suggesting Phantasy Star, but that's, like, a huge RPG. Yeah, I don't know. We don't really have much time to explore that. But yeah, okay. Anyway, check this out. So you got trophies, blah, blah, blah. That's to be expected. But you have, like, a challenge section. Win the Kung Fung tournament, but your health bar is looking low. So you can do, like, little mini challenges. You can hit the square button. Oh, that's really cool. Look at that shit. And now we're just here in a comic zone again. Oh, yeah. I can get behind these challenges. This is neat. What do you mean my health bar's looking low? I've operated on far less than this bullshit in the Kung Fung tournament. Alright, Striggles, you just really want to get in close and give him one of those kicks to the, right in the fucking face. Mortis, not a big deal either. Just gotta make sure they don't get their ranged attacks off. Oh my shit, I love Comic Zone. I actually own, thanks to my beautiful wife, the Comic Zone cartridge and the instruction booklet. I don't have the CD. The CD is like uber rare that came with it. But I do have everything else, and I'm so happy with it. It's a fantastic game. Yeah, these guys are dicks. I don't actually know a good way to deal with their counterattacks. So I kind of just more or less repeatedly punch them. Surely there's a better way. And these assholes, like I mentioned earlier, whoops, roadkill. You just throw your rat at him. Oh, yes. Oh, she kind of liked it. And there she goes. Kung Fung tournament is a done. And look at that. We didn't even use our fist. But if we do use the fist, the guy's like, you're a fucking cheater. And then you got to fight him again. All right, let's go. Wow, that is so cool. Look at that. I like this challenge shit. This is really neat. One attempt and a success. That's what I like to see. Complete round 10. Oh, Flicky's in this too. Good. Oh, no. Fuck that. We got Mean Bean challenges. Never mind. I don't like it anymore. Golden Axe, Shining Force. Shadow Dancer. What the fuck is Shadow Dancer? Complete stage 1-2 with the dog in its puppy state? What? Rice Star. Without taking damage. Green Hill Zone. Act 2 in Mirror Mode. In under 1 minute. So the game will be mirrored. And beat it in under a minute. Oh, Jesus. What the fuck is this? So, it's mirrored, but your controls are also mirrored, so it's kind of- oh, shit. It's kind of, forgiving in that way. Also, this is Sonic 1, I'm trying to fucking spin dash. Yeah, it's over. GG. Oh my god, I haven't played Sonic in a millennium. Yeah, this is cool. So, even though it's mirrored, it's not like, you know, you're fucked on your controller. Your controller still works just fine. Oh, nice. I like this. Moonsidian, music is forward. 0 out of 10. That's a... That's a really good point. Music backwards would have been so much better. The amount of fucking times I have died as a child and apparently as an adult to being like, oh, I got invincibility, and then just fucking falling into that pit is legendary. Jesus, that pit kills me so often. Space Harrier without losing a life. Streets of Rage without picking up any items. These challenges are pretty flippin' nifty. perform an epic comeback to win the fight. Ooh, Vector Man. I've never really played Vector Man. I've played a little bit. I had a friend that had Vector Man. I never owned it myself. Huh, yeah, these are cool. And you have some leaderboards here. Which, I guess my internet isn't fucking working? Because there's like nothing on the leaderboards either. Oh well. Tough titties, right? Alright, anyway. Challenges are over. Lastly, let us check out... What the fuck Shadow Dancer is. I have no idea what this game is. Oh god, I heard a little bit of Sonic there. That was cool. Shadow Adanza. 1990. What is this, a Ninja Gaiden kind of game?
1997, New York City. Having vanquished the evil crime empire Neo Zed, Shinobi was not heard from again. His combat ninja skills were not needed in a peaceful world. But a new threat arose in a reptilian form that lived on vicious instinct alone. The colossal monster moved slowly and quietly, and its attack was relentless. The souls unfortunate enough to live became hostages. Mass panic swept the streets. It remained only for a shinobi to take action. The ninja of the shadows, his weapons were sold. The quickness of the attack was ever blind. The ninja was some faithful dog. It is a story of defiance. There we go.
Oh shit, I got a pupper. Oh, we're in a demo mode. I was like actually trying to play. Demo is attack enemy. Make sure you look around like an asshole. Dog will boof. Throw shuriken. Dodge helicopter. This game actually looks pretty cool. Cool demo, man. I appreciate that. Oh shit, hold on. Check this music out. Oh, that's what I'm talking about. Fucking 90s. Yes. That's some good music. Alright. Not what I expect from a ninja game. Burning downtown. Alright, we got shurikens. We have a bomb attack, which I definitely just wasted. Yes! Well done. I like the boofs from the dog. Really enhances my experience here. We got Sunset Riders up jumps. We got Sunset Riders like hostages and shit to pick up. Ooh, almost got hit there. I guess there's a slight delay with my capture card. Or maybe it's OBS? I'm not sure. But just a very tiny little delay. Look at this fucking dog. He's so fucking pissed. Son, I know. I'm trying. I'm trying so hard. I don't know what to do. Use the sword. Oh, okay, yeah. Gotta get in melee range for those jackasses. So the dog... Oh, headshot. The dog is like slightly annoying. I'm just gonna go ahead and say it right now. Just a little bit. Oh, and I can't throw upward. Oh, wait. I can charge dog? What? What the fuck does this do? Charge dog! Oh, shit, I used my bomb. Whoops. Going near with the good... Not advice, but saying it might be the capture card. A little bit of a lag when they stream. Yeah. Oh well, can't be helped. I mean, I wonder if streaming just directly from the PS4 would help. But I don't know. I don't know how that all works, streaming directly from the console. I'm a fucking old man. I barely know how all this shit works. This guy's a fucking prick, by the way. And my dog- Shut up, dog! Remember in Chappelle's Show when the cops burst in? They're like, shut that fucking dog up! That's how I feel right now, minus shooting it in the face. Power up! You rescued a woman. What does charged dog do? Oh shit, son! What was that? He like charges at him. Yes! Okay, I can't really high jump that far. Am I gonna die? I don't want to, like, accidentally touch this guy. Huzzo! What? Hit, please. I guess those guys are off limit. Oh, shit! What was that? I am so confused as to what's happening right now, but somehow it all worked out, I guess. This game's kind of neat. I don't mind it. I like this main character. He goes, "Ha!" a lot. Yeah, get him, boy! Oh! So yeah, you can't sick your dog on shield, bro, I guess. Or I guess you can sometimes. Nice. Alright, get us the power of woman. Oh yeah, I'm feeling that. Feeling that Genki energy from that lady. There's a dude down here. Rescuing dudes is just not worth my time, right? Yeah, that's just points. Who cares? Yeah, you gotta rescue the females. Get that power up. Oh, shit! These enemies just spawning are literally killing me. Oh! Dog, no! What the fuck? Oh, he came back. Thank God. That was horrifying. Fucker jumped straight into that pit. Oh, yep, and then there's a rock. Nice. I got the salamander, though, so we got a one-up. Why does sometimes I die and sometimes I don't? I'm a little confused by the mechanics here. Though I do like having this power up. We're good. So there's the exit. But I bet you we can get some good shit if we keep going up. Oh, really? Nothing, huh? Alright. We'll play, like, a little bit more. Maybe we'll try to get through this chapter. I wonder if there's... wonder if we're at the boss. Yeah, oh yeah, here we go. Oh shit, dude, here we go. I can combine this. Where's my doggo, though? Oh! Hey, Iron Fury, how you doing? Now let's try that again. Alright, this fucking asshole. Probably need to hit him in, like, the head, I would reckon. Ugh! God damn, the same fucking way. Alan, what are you doing? Let's try to actually play a video game. How does that sound? Yeah, we need to hit him in the head. This fucking... His rocks. Oh, these rocks. Shadow Dancer. Yeah, are you familiar with Shadow Dancer? I had never played it. I have no idea what I'm doing. I'm not gonna lie. But it seems really fucking cool, actually. Oh, yeah, that's death. Jesus. Yeah, I suck dick at this game, apparently. Oh, listen to this little sad music. Familiar with the Shinobi series, but never played this. Oh, man. Come on. Oh, wait, we are at 130. Good. So how do I dodge the rocks without being a complete asshole here? Go in here. Ugh, God, it's just so slow. Maybe there's like an evade button that I'm missing? Let's see. Doesn't look like it. Can't really double tap. Oh, the fire too? Shit. Yeah, there's nothing funny about this here, Ninja Boy. Super Ninja Boy, that's a video game. Just waiting for that fire. Yep, here it is. What? Alan actually learned something. What? I like how the fire just fucking fell, like, straight to the ground. Pro strats, just hand to the back and, spam shurikens, I guess. This is cool, though. I like this. Welcome to the bonus stage! Oh, this music is dope! Shoot the ninjas! Oh! Well, fuck me, right? I already missed one. It's always so satisfying when you just miss something immediately in a bonus stage. like this music. It's like, yeah, yeah. Revenge of Shinobi and Shinobi 3 in particular have excellent music, Iron Fury says. Might have to look into those. When it comes to Sega Genesis, I've played like minimal games. So this collection is pretty neat. It has a lot of good games on it. Battle on the Big Bridge, RD2. All right. Play a little bit. We'll just play till we game over. Hey, I got my dog back. Nice. Sega Genesis still sitting on my desk, Iron Fury says. As I'm reading chat, I get backstabbed. Whoops. Hell yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Oh, fuck. Can't turn around fast enough. I am not meant for this game, am I? Yeah, I still have my Super Nintendo hooked up to a CRT, and I do have a Genesis. It just, I need the cables for it. Somehow I can't find the fucking connection cables. And also I need some games. I don't have any of my Sega games. I have Comic Zone, Home Alone, and Sonic 1 are the only fucking games I have. It's kind of a travesty. Oh, God. Home Alone, yes! The first game I've ever played with a fucking crafting system. And why are you a puppy right now? What happened? Why are you a fucking puppy? You are so adorable. What happened? Yeah, Home Alone is great on the Genesis, and I don't know why, but it's actually really good. Yes, yeah, Iron Fury is saying it's better than it has any right to be. Absolutely. It's actually really solid. Echo the Dolphin, oof. Echo the Dolphin is really good. Talk about a weird fucking game. Echo the Dolphin, you're like, oh, it's really beautiful, you know, you're exploring, you gotta solve puzzles. And then shit just gets fucking crazy in that game. But yeah, Home Alone's fantastic. And I will debate anyone otherwise. Okay, oh, there it is. Yeah, you can tell I clearly suck dick at this game. Didn't Genesis also have that like really good Ghostbusters game? And like, it was like the best way to play it? Iron Fury mentioned that it's like the best Home Alone game is on the Genesis. Yeah, okay, so yeah, Genesis had the best Ghostbusters game. And then, fuck your ass with that pistol. Also, in my personal opinion, the best Aladdin game. I really much prefer Aladdin on the Genesis than the Super Nintendo variant. It was just really solid. European NES Ghostbusters 2 game. Huh. No shit. Yeah, we're just gonna try out this wind jutsu. Hell yeah, okay, cool. There's a lot more people I need to save here, by the way, than our previous levels. Alright, dog, just get him. Fuck, what happened? I don't know how to handle the shield, bros. Screen nukes, yes. Whatever happened to screen nukes, anyway? I feel kind of bad, Iron Fury. You joined right when I was about to shut it down. Because it is, like, almost my bedtime. It's late as shit for me. Okay. Let's just, we'll actually be a ninja here. We'll drop in, we'll just slash him right in the ass. Yes! Yeah, that's how we handle it. Alright. Revenge of Shinobi is considered the classic of the series. Okay. Good to know, good to know. Trying to learn as much as possible about my, my Sega Genesis shit. All I know is what I like. Otherwise, yeah, very little about it. Alright, so, you're a cunt. And you kick my dog. Oh, now he's a puppy. I'm kind of not terribly upset by that. Puppy is adorable. Okay, here we go. Maybe I can do this time. Yeah, wow. Hardest thing I've ever done, isn't it? Oh, there we go. Power up. Now things are coming up, Milhouse. One thing that kind of annoys me in this game is you can't attack people on like a different fucking plane unless you're up there with them. And I'm gonna get... Oh, we're good. Jesus. This game... I guess it's one of those. You gotta be a little bit patient with it. Can't just rush in like an asshole like I've been doing. And that looks really suspicious. Like, I want to go there. Let's try this bomb attack. Oh, yeah, there's a one-up. Fuck yeah. Look at that. How do we get that? Oh, it's a two-up. Oh, dog, no. God, the dog jumping to his death kills me every time. Oh, shit. Oh, no, 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 no. I'm right at the end. You dirty cocktease, you. What's that? Time and space rewind. No, I'm just kidding. I'm not going to do that. Shinobi 3 is much faster in that regard. Interesting. It's so cool to have someone that actually knows fucking good shit about the Shinobi series. It's Spider-Man and Godzilla bosses, so they had to be removed. You are kidding me. It had a fucking Spider-Man boss? Like, literally Spider-Man. Oh boy. Also, our hostages stay rescued. Nice. Iron Fury says it was legitimately Spider-Man and Godzilla. Wow. Beautiful. What were they thinking, I wonder? Probably just going with, like, popular shit at the time, huh? Well, I guess we're just gonna go straight to the exit and nuke the shit out of everything here. Hopefully it gets rid of that projectile. Or that guy spawning. It did. Nice. Oi, oi, oi. Yeah, that would be cool. Just post it on Brian's Discord. You can also post it on mine if you want. You're welcome. I am totally just trying to get as many people on there as possible. Because seeing people chat and shit while I'm at work makes it go by a lot faster. And it makes me laugh. Okay, shield bro. Let's... Oh! Oh, my shin! Oh! How am I a shinobi if I don't have my shin? I'm just an obi. That was fucking terrible. I clearly need to go to bed. Oh, my other shin. Jesus. Yeah, there should be a link down below the Twitch. Or it's also on like my YouTube videos nowadays. I'm linking to that there. Alright, let's just duck walk. I can do the duck walk. Thank you, Link. CDI Link. Oh, we gotta get that stripper back there. Oh! Oh, baby! Whoa! Intense action. Oh shit, he's still alive. What a fucking ass. Get out of here. What is your actual strategy, my man? All right, how do we get back there? Whoa, there we go. Never bring a katana to a fucking pistol fight. Oh, baby. I said I was gonna stop after like one continue, but I'm just still playing this game. It's really fucking fun. I mean, I know I suck dicks at it, but I'm still having a lot of fun. I don't get the charging dog mechanic. I just don't understand. Alright, so Iron Fear is saying it was Spider-Man and Batman. You're taking the piss right now. Spider-Man and Batman? Really? So you're telling me, as a ninja, I can just murder these iconic heroes. Oh, fuck. I'm fucked. Got surrounded. Oh, I forgot I had a bomb. Damn it. What am I thinking? Yeah, get out of here, you bitches. I like this guy's like, yeah, get out of here. Don't come over to my fence. Oh, I'm gonna come over to that fence. You can't break this fence. Oh, I can break this fence. Here we go. Boom! Meteor! The forbidden magics! You can't use that! Oh, but I just did. And I got a stripper for my efforts. Which allows me to shoot bigger blasts. Thicker meteor blasts. Oh, get kicked in the face, you piece of shit. Oh! Hidden items. Yeah, hidden one-ups. Nice, take it. Posting them both. Nice, thank you. I'll check that out here in a minute. When I hopefully go to bed, because it's late, but I'm sitting here playing this fucking game still. How am I gonna get to this jackass, I wonder? I guess I could sneak over here. He's probably gonna, yeah, he's gonna jump over. These guys kinda aggro you, don't they? Aggro! Alright. Please, there we go. Hey, look at that! Nice. Shinobi 3 is my favorite of the Genesis Shinobi series, by the way, so check that shit out when you can. It's fucking awesome. One of my favorite Genesis games. Okay, yeah. I am interested in this. Was Shinobi 3... Hold on, let me check this out. I know we're at a boss, but... Was that in this? Shadow Dancer. Oh, shit, son. Look at that, Iron Fury. Boom. Get you some Shinobi 3 on this collection also. Nice. This is a really fucking good collection, isn't it? I gotta say, 30 bucks? Not bad. Alright, we're at a boss, and I'm not full screened. Hold on, pause. Pause, boss. Here we go. Oh, Christ! Nightmares! What are you? Jesus! Has science gone too far? Oh, Uncle Grabby Hands! No! Yeah, I was actually talking about Sonic's Ultimate Genesis Collection earlier in the stream, and talking about how it was frustrating that you actually had to, like, unlock shit in that. Because I fucking hate Mean Bean Machine, and you had to, like, play Mean Bean Machine to unlock. I can't remember what it was. But yeah, and then in this game, everything just kind of starts unlocked, so it's really nice. At least that I know of. I hope there's not, like, hidden locked shit. What am I talking about? There's not hidden shit anymore. Everything's just DLC. Oh, you had to unlock non-Genesis games, Iron Fury says. Okay. Yeah, I remember something that just kind of frustrated me. Yeah, I mean, it makes sense, but I suck ass at Mean Bean Machine. Bonus games, yeah. Okay, fair enough. So it wasn't like you're missing out on the huge Genesis titles. You're just missing out on some of like the arcade variants and whatnot. So I'm noticing a theme in this game. If you... fuck. If you're fighting a boss, just try and get fucking far away and spam shurikens. What I'm seeing here. Alright. Yep. Oh, might be too... No, we're not too close. Should have capitalized on that. Oh, this is gonna be a shit show. This is a really cool boss, though. It's like a brick elemental. It's fucking creepy. Oh, come on. Do some damage there. I hit him multiple times. Oh, this might be it for our heroes. For our intrepid heroes. But wait. Fire Jutsu. Saved my ass. Yes. Trump's wall. Absolutely. Trump is coming up too much in this stream. Gotta shut it down. Hey, we did it. With like one life and zero continues left. We fucking did it. Cool games. Oh, this is my music right here. Blah, blah, blah.
Yo.
Blah. It's so fucking bad. No, it's so good. It's rad is what I meant to say. Yeah. Totally rad. Just mash that fucking cross button like your crotch depends on it. No, you fuck. This is so good. I know I'm not moving, but it's so good. Shit. Worth it for the music. Yeah, 10,000. All right. The Statue of Liberty is fucking RD3. What kind of games were you thinking about, Iron Fury? He was saying, oh, there it is, the shin shot. Frustrating that some of those games, some games don't make it onto these. Puzzle platformer called Trampoline Terror. What the fuck are you talking about, Trampoline Terror? That sounds horrifying. Puzzle platformer? I have never even heard of that game. Alright, get him, boy. Yeah! Yeah, rip his crotch off. Whoa, we got Sonic! Sonic Spinball there. Did an LP of it, Iron Fury. Okay, cool. I may have to go to your channel and look at that. Maybe sooner that rather than later, because I just got fucked with the shield. That game was more fun than I thought it would be. I enjoyed that a lot. The Secret of Shinobi. Yeah, I didn't even know it was a fucking Shinobi game. I just kind of started it up. Iron Fury, didn't you do that like... a million years ago. Also, Iron Fury, You can... Where did I change the time here? Hold on. Where was that? Yeah, here we go. So you can actually change the time of day if you want some real realism. And look, like the light kind of passes through the window there. All the way into the morning. It's so fucking pointless, but it's pretty cool. And each game has like little extras, right? Okay, so yeah, like this is how you get the trophy from that game. This guy has a Sonic rug. Hey, Fromato, how you doing? So yeah, you get the trophies, and then some of these have like leaderboard data. Which, what the fuck? Why is the leaderboard working now? I tried to do multiplayer earlier, and it just was like, nah, man, you're good. Maybe I need to filter shit. I don't know. Yeah, it's got some really cool shit with the extras, so you can see like your leaderboard data. Online multiplayer is fucking awesome. You can play Toe Jam and Earl across the states easily. Oh, hey, look at this, guys. Oh, no! Oh, he declined me. What a cunt. I was going to say we got into a Toe Jam and Earl match, but that guy didn't want to play with me, I guess. Fuck you, then. Let's try it one more time. If I get into a Toe Jam and Earl match, the stream's going to go on a billion years. Exiting multiplayer? That's cool. That's my favorite game, where you just exit multiplayer. Let's play that again. Yeah, Iron Fury, we could sometime. That may actually be fun. But I kind of suck a lot of dick at most of these, so... Alright, are we jiggling? Golden Axe, wow. I'm a noob at Golden Axe, but I could definitely give it a shot. Alright, let's try this again. You can favorite your games. So like you put it on the other side of this die here so you can make sure you can come back to it really easily. Golden Axe 3 never came out to the States proper. Really? That's cool. But it was always in English. What the fuck? That hurts my brain, man. Come on, someone get in here. Okay, yeah, and then I was showing off. You can favorite. You got the extras. Oh, yeah, check this shit out, Iron Fury. You can also change the region. So, like, if you want to play fucking Dynamite Heady, but you want it to be reasonable... You can hit L3 and you can play like the Japanese version on some of these games. Really cool. Yeah, check it out. Boom. Japanese. Like that. Good shit. Also, I guess multiplayer is still broken. I thought we might be able to get something there, but... Not in the cards tonight. Streets of Rage 3 was noticeably easier in Japan. Cool. Golden Axe 3 was only on the Sega Channel. Fuck. Yeah, I never had Sega Channel. I was spoiled as shit as a kid, but no, didn't have Sega Channel. And I don't think I even asked for it. I don't even think I knew what it was, to be honest with you guys. Oh, and also, on top of all that, you have little challenges, which I'm sure you will kick ass at, where you can just play like different games. Like I already did the Comic Zone one, which is Kung Fung Tournament, but your health bar is low. Yeah, and it records how many times you failed at it, which is cool. It's just neat little shit. Oh, hey, I got a trophy. Nice. Oh, I got two trophies. I'm feeling so fulfilled right now. My cup runneth over with fulfillment. All right, once more, but we're probably just going to shut the stream down. Because I am a tired, goofy boy right now. Searching for players. Ugh. Iron Fury is thinking about tackling more of these Genesis games. If he ever decides to get YouTube running again. Yeah. Yeah, definitely. I say you should. I mean, if you enjoy it, why not do it? That's fucking awesome. I love doing this shit. Crackdown. Here we go. Fuck yeah, I happen to be an expert at Crackdown, so yeah, let's go, Dark Guy 11, or Dark Guyver 31. Also, I've played fucking Crackdown once, so I feel like I'm about to ruin this guy's day. Did you just do a one-player game? Darkgyver 1? You dirty bastard. Yeah, you all need to get back on YouTube, for sure. Okay. Oh, I joined in. Yeah, here we go. Andy, you're already dead, you fuck. Yeah, look at this. Online gameplay. On a fucking Sega Genesis. This is the real shit. Oh, yeah. Oh, you dirty bastard. I forgot how to play fucking Crackdown already. Like I said, I've only played it once. This guy's just throwing out smart bombs. Jesus. Oh, no! Alright, I gotta step up my game here for Darkgyver. Oh, he's just running. He's just gonna punch him in the dick. No, you gotta change your bullets, Guyver. Here, I got you, man. Just hang tight. Stay in cover. No. Here, I'll smart bomb him. Here we go. Hoya! Power up. Yeah, get the fuck out of here in this truck. I should not be better than you at this game, Darkgyver. And I'm not judging you. You're a cool guy. You actually stuck around, but I should not be better than you at this. Alright, so we got... Where is he even going? There's not an X over there, you dingus. Let's just throw out one of these. This game is pretty fucking cool, though. I didn't know what kind of game I was even in for, but it's pretty cool. Also, hope you get out by... Oh, well, he's dead. Never mind. Come on, Guyver. Hit that... Smash that like button, boyo. Welp. Not having it, huh? I don't blame you. So is he gonna join me again? No, he's fucking gone, isn't he? How can you tell if he's like still in the game? Like, is he watching me right now? I don't know. Yeah, he's still there. Oh, okay, cool, he joined. Oh shit, he can still like play while I'm on the main menu there. That's neat. Alright, oh. Here we go. Let's split up. I'll take the northern path here. Or you'll just leave. Alright, fair enough. No, he's pausing it. Say, if you want to leave, man. He can't actually hear me. I'm just talking to myself, but, you know. Oh, bullshit. Alright, Guyver, you're killing my vibes here with all these pausings. Also, did he just friendly fire me? I think he just fucking shot me in the face. I thought that was an enemy. Oh, Lord. Andy! Ever since he got rid of Woody, you just haven't been the same, man. Alright, get these fucking X's. You take care of the one down there. I got shit to do up here, my man. We have shit to do. Oh, here we go. Yeah, clutch. Smart bomb. Oh, I don't have any smart bombs. Let's get some missiles. Alright, you guys are fucked now. Yeah, look at all this damage I'm doing. Yeah! Oh yeah, we're toast. We're toast. Fuck. Name entry. Alright, Darkgyver, I hope you're of age to see such graphic language that I'm about to enter. Wow, could this be any slower? Channeling my Chandler Bing right now. Yeah, number 7. I'm gonna get reported. Sony's gonna ban my ass. There it is. Boom. How do I actually enter it? For real? I'm just like fucking stuck. There it is. The legend of ass. He's fucking screaming at his TV. That motherfucker, did you just call me an ass? I'll fucking kill you. Full of rage. I'm sure. This was a really fun stream. One that I am not against doing again, to be honest with you. I don't really know what I'd play. We have to get some toe jam going at some point. Dark Guyver, I know you can't hear me, but thank you. That was awesome. No thanks. I'm leaving. See ya, bud. But yeah, we gotta get toe jam sometime. Faux show. We could always do more Fatal Labyrinth, even though I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. I love that game. Gain Ground, what the fuck is this? There's still games I haven't even played. Yeah, I don't know. A lot of good shit. That was satisfying. Anyways. Gungnir is suggesting spending time on a Phantasy Star game. And a Shining Force suggestion from Iron Fury. I never played those. There were some pretty awesome RPGs on the Sega that I just omitted because I was such a Chrono Trigger fanboy when I was a child. Implying I'm not still a fucking Chrono Trigger fanboy. And we could always do some online. I could always play if Iron Fury, if you end up getting it, or anyone else, really. We could just fuck around and play a beat-em-up, do whatever. It doesn't matter. Vector Man. Oh, yeah. I've never really played Vector Man. We could check that out, too. I think I will make this a thing we'll come back to. Yeah. Fuck around in Golden Axe. Oh, it'll all be good. Let me go ahead and just get this here. We can actually get a little bit of chat displayed. I would also kind of like a way to display chat while I'm playing it, but I don't want to really fuck with the resolution too much. Like, I don't want too much real estate just being like a chat box. I'm not really sure how I want to orient that. Or even if I do want to fuck with that. A lot to think about. Oh, what? Now that I have the chat box up, none of you assholes are talking? People are going to think I was just, being a complete weirdo. No, that was really fun. Seriously, thank you guys so much. There it is. Iron Fury's talking. Yeah, that was a good stream. And, again, thank you all for watching. Really appreciate it. And we'll definitely come back to this, for sure. Probably really shortly. We're going to resume Earthbound here. Earthbound Reshuffled. And I don't know if I'm going to do the Link to the Past one anytime soon, because, let's be honest, I suck ass at it. And I think it's kind of bland, because I just don't know what's going on. So I might replace it with this, and just do random bullshit. Feels good to play Sega. Again, not really one I mess around with too much. So yeah. Drop in the Discord, chat it up with me, hang out, and we will be back, I guess, tomorrow? Is that when I'm doing it? Sure. Super Mario World randomizer, that's batshit. Oh, boy. Yeah, when we're done with Reshuffled Earthbound, we could probably go ahead and just do some more randomizers. That could be a lot of fun. Anyways, I could literally talk to you guys forever, so just abrupt ending.